suck it up. Get up, get out of bed. I know it's going to be a tough one, but we're going to make it a whole lot better. Welcome to your feel-good kickstart to a brand new week. Welcome to it.
Morning, gentlemen.
Back from the weekend, guys. How are we all doing? We're good?
We are good.
Yeah, like rock and roll, man.
Oh, it was a magic weekend. I got to tell you, Mzansi, but we'll get into that in just a bit. For now, though, what better way to kick off the week than with some mad inspiration from my ever-inspiring local youth. We're talking about 13-year-old fencing champion Gemma Bellini, who's in here, in the building here, and ready to give us a slice of her life. And so is local karate kid Jay Lee. Will take us through her path. I don't even know about Jay Lee, but
I know she's normally appearing on the show in a very different guise, modeling not a gi, but a very different kind of outfit. But today she shows her karate chops, which is awesome.
And I love the name as well. I only click now, I'm like Bruce Lee, Jet Li.
Yes, Jay Lee. It's in the name.
Oh, like
it's
water, my friend, like water.
Oh, well, someone else following in mom's footsteps, you know, Chef Teresa, while her youngster, Maggie, will be whipping up some puff pastry Easterness. So we are so excited for that. So really looking forward to it.
Yeah, and we're going to be humbled by the level of talent, I think is the best way to approach it and kind of gauge our involvement. We're going to be entertained by the most incredibly talented group of young pianists ahead of the Stellenbosch International Piano Symposium. We've been listening to sound checks this morning, and it's like someone's just put a track on and left it on. Every now and then you notice there's actually a teenager, a young person playing that music.
And it is live.
Yeah, it's crazy, man. They're going to blow you away this morning, and that's why we are here, to be inspired.
Definitely, and we love inspiring and connecting with you. So let's take a look at our Good Morning post that's on social media. We're asking you all about celebrating up-and-coming stars.
Yeah, and we want to know from you, is your child going to be a future actor, performer, or Olympian?
Yes.
And we want you to flex your kids and tell us about their talents. And please come through, because we know that you want to rep your kids tonight. I know you're vicariously living through some of your children right now. So, Mzansi, come on, get involved in this one. Show off your kids, show off your talents, and let us know who we should be looking out for and getting on the couch soon to have an interview with.
Oh,
right?
Buddy, you're going to be so proud. I can't wait. We're going to go through our weekend highlights just before 7 o'clock this morning. Little man, you better be watching today, dude.
You got a young Olympian there, bro.
Oh, man, not quite. Well, maybe. It depends if they make it an Olympic sport or not, but you might champion for. But had the most amazing weekend. I think all of you get to share in your weekend as well. So connect with us this morning. Please share your inspiration. If your little one has done something or is going to do something truly miraculous, it's our time to, yes, live vicariously through our kids and be oh so proud. But of course, we do have real life to chew on this morning. We'll get into some massive sporting results from this weekend. Sorry, boys. Sorry. And of course, those news headlines to set the tone for a brand new week. So he's got the latest on the news front.
Thank you, gentlemen. Let's start off with your national headlines. A 32-year-old woman has been arrested in connection with the disappearance of 6-year-old Jocelyn Smith from Saldanha Bay on the Cape West Coast. This after police earlier said more people were taken in for questioning as part of the investigation. Last week, 3 accused, including the child's mother, appeared in court. The search for the little girl, however, continues. She went missing from her home in the Middelpos informal settlement on the 19th of February. The latest suspect is expected to appear in the Vredenburg Magistrates Court today. And 3 rhino poachers arrested in 2020 have started serving their jail terms after they were convicted and sentenced by the Katu Magistrates Court in the Northern Cape. David Metlui, 27, Katamile Cooper, 26, and Taboho Magare, 27, were sentenced to a combined 75 years in prison on several counts. They were each found guilty on 8 counts, including contravention of the Immigration Act, possession of unlicensed firearms, and entering the Republic with wild animals. All 3 men were handed 25-year direct imprisonment. Moving to news beyond our own borders, or should I say underwater, widespread internet outages were reported on Thursday in countries including South Africa, Nigeria, Ivory Coast, Liberia and Ghana. Since then, services have largely been restored in Liberia and South Africa. The cause of the cable failures was not immediately clear, much to the frustration of millions of customers around the continent. There seems to be a pattern in the timing of the disruptions impacting from the north to the south of Africa, said Cloudflare Radar, which provides information on internet connections. A retired expert said sometimes undersea cables do get cut even by debris. And a state of emergency has been declared in southern Iceland after another volcanic eruption on the Reykjanes Peninsula, the fourth since December. Lava has reached the small evacuated town of Grindavik. The powerful and fast lava flows began late on Saturday, but the authorities say they have since diminished significantly. Activity around the fissure, initially some 3 kilometers long, had also dissipated. Iceland's meteorological office said the streams of lava were still flowing yesterday, but the rate at which they were flowing had begun to slow down. And amidst the enchanting setting of Kersenbosch Botanical Gardens, the adored Good Luck Band last night captivated thousands of concertgoers with exhilarating news. Ben Peters and Jules Harding delightfully unveiled the gender of their soon-to-be baby live on stage, igniting exuberant cheers. And yes, it's a girl. The crowd joyfully counted down to the reveal in chanced by Jules, Ben and the fellow bandmate Tim Walsh, popping bottles to release pink-hued smoke, adding a charming touch to the moment. Ben and Jules, who kept their relationship private for 15 years, are now eagerly anticipating the arrival of their little girl, who will soon be joining them on their life's journey. Jules earlier said they were, and I quote, giddy with excitement to be bringing a new soul into this wonderful world. Well, that is where I leave those headlines. Let's hope the sport is a wonderful world.
Oh, Ben and Jules, we love you. Just waiting for that pulsating banger to come out, the first ever most incredible song written about their little one, and it's, I'm sure, in the works, but absolutely beautiful, man. Well, let's see, his hopes were dashed over the weekend, and who is celebrating in a pulsating FA Cup quarterfinal? Man United. They dashed Liverpool's hopes of a quadruple with Amad Diallo's decisive goal in a thrilling 4-3 victory. And that was after extra time. So Erik ten Hag's side, they mounted two late comebacks, overcoming Liverpool's lead twice in the game. Scott McTominay, he opened the scoring before goals from Alexis McAllister and Mohamed Salah put Liverpool ahead. And Antony's equaliser forced to extra time, where Harvey Elliott restored Liverpool's lead, and with a Marcus Rashford levelled the score once again before Diallo sealed that United win in extra time, extra added time. Incredible stuff. So United now faces Coventry City in the semi-finals at Wembley on the weekend of April the 20th and 21st. Then they were going for the Grand Slam, didn't quite get it, but Ireland clinched their Six Nations title nonetheless with a hard-fought 17-13 victory over Scotland at Lansdowne Road on Saturday. Tries from Dan Sheehan and Andrew Porter proved decisive in the end as the hosts encountered some stiff resistance from a much stronger Scotland side, a very formidable defence throughout that match. And although denied the chance for a historic Grand Slam following last weekend's defeat to England, Ireland's consecutive title triumphs echo the achievements of Joe Schmidt's side in 2014 and 2015, another golden era. Now we bring it back home, or at least to African soil, for the African Games playing out in Accra. And Team South Africa kicked off their African Games campaign in style, dominating hosts Ghana with a commanding 134-run victory at the Achimota Cricket Oval on Sunday. So captain George van Heerden, he led the charge with a magnificent maiden T20 century, scoring an unbeaten 107 off just 57 balls. Incredible, featuring 8 fours and 7 sixes. South Africa posting an imposing total of 237 for 2 after opting to go into bat first. Then Ghana, they struggled in that chase, managing only 103 for 7 in their 20. So Team South Africa set to face Kenya today at the same venue, looking to extend that winning streak, obviously. Now, speaking of which, let's turn to tennis. And world number one Scottie Scheffler made history by becoming the first player to secure back-to-back victories at the Players' Championship with a remarkable 8-under-par 64 on Sunday. Obviously, talking about golf. Now, clinching a one-stroke triumph at the TPC Sawgrass, Wyndham Clark, Brian Harman and Xander Schauffele. They finished just one shot behind Scheffler, with Clark narrowly missing a playoff opportunity after his birdie attempt on the 18th hole just narrowly missed, leaving the agony. But a great outing for Scheffler nonetheless. And that's where we leave our sport for now. We're bringing in the young stars throughout the show to inspire you about the future hopes of South African sports. But right now, let's inspire you with the week ahead. Get some of those weather warnings in and see what the temperatures look like today.
Thank you so much, G-Man. Yes, let's dive into all things weather right now. And the SA Weather Service has warned that extreme high fire danger conditions are expected over the Northern Cape, the central and western parts of the Free State, as well as the southwestern parts of the Northwest. Now, heatwave conditions and persistent high temperatures are expected over Northwest, the Free State, and the Northern Cape until tomorrow. Now, meanwhile, a fire in the mountains at Harlem, a small town on the outskirts of the George Municipal Precinct, has been contained. And municipal spokesperson Ntobeke Mangwengwe says light rain contributed to a decrease in temperatures and a reduction in fire intensity. Now, teams from the Garden Route District Municipality Fire and Working on Fire remained on site to conduct mop-up operations and monitor the area throughout the night. Now, the cause of the fire is unknown and there's been no damage to property. Well, for more weather news, let's dive into that edition of the day where you can see exactly what you can expect in your side of town. And I'm talking about those temperatures. So have a look and we'll discuss the rest of it the next hour.
They've taken all of the heat from the rest of the country and they're just keeping it right there. And we'll cool you down. Hopefully we'll cool you down with lots of cash. In fact, we'll make it rain lots of cash this March with an estimated 450,000 rand. Nice. That is the jackpot this Monday. Play now and stand a chance to make it a very, very big payday.
Oh, well, there are many ways to buy your ticket. Okay. You can buy your ticket in store. You can buy it on the nationallottery.co.za website. You can buy it through your mobile app, through your cell phone banking, or by simply dialing *120*7529# for USSD.
Super, super simple, and we've made it even simpler by keeping all of those details up on our social media pages, so you've got no excuses. You can make it rain. Even if you are in Upington, you can still make it rain cash today. 450,000 rand is the daily lotto jackpot today, and it should be yours. I'm going to manifest on your behalf. Go out and get it, but you've got to play to put yourself in the running. Likewise, you've got to stick around to put yourself in the running for the rest of the show, and there's a lot going on.
It is a musical Monday, and the piano symposium at Stellenbosch University is coming up, and we've got some of the artists here to really get our Monday starting on the right note.
Yeah, and humble us with the levels of talent. They are insanely gifted young people, and we cannot wait for that. And then, of course, we are all about inspiring the creative arts, and we found an artist resource that is blowing our mind this morning. We're going to plug you into the Jakela Studios as they help build the dreams of artists of the future, give them some practical tools to really let them fly. We're going to inspire you this morning. Stick around, we'll plug into that on the other side of this.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Welcome back. We promised you talent to blow your mind, and we have it in spades this morning. Joining us right now is Professor Nina Schoeman from the University of Stellenbosch, we know well, and one of the organizers of the Stellenbosch International Piano Symposium. What a platform. Alongside her are students who are making use of this opportunity from the Stellenbosch University. It's Reyno Boysen and Chanda Lupambo. Let's give them a very feel-good Monday morning welcome. Nina, you've softened the blow. You've been here this early on a Monday. You know what it feels like, gents. Thank you for being here. But listening to your sound check, I think you are ready to embrace these moments. And what a moment, Nina, to have, to be able to play alongside your peers, to be able to show your talent, and have the platform to put it out there. So maybe that's a good place to start with the Stellenbosch International Piano Symposium. What is the purpose here? What are we trying to create?
Well, it's essentially a gathering of piano nerds.
I love that. Superheroes.
To put it. It's truly a gathering of participants and young talent from all over the country. Then we also get a substantial amount of observers who are mainly school teachers or private teachers, and then university professors. So it's 5 days of concerts, jam-packed with masterclasses, with lectures. And of course, it's also open to the wider public, and everything culminates in the final evening, which is called the Piano Extravaganza, where we start with one piano, then two, then four, then six, and eventually 10, with 20 pianos on stage.
Yeah. Which is, as I understand, awe-inspiring to try and wrap your head around, to see that level of complexity. There is something in it, yes. I love the fact that the mentoring is going up and down. There is a sharing of knowledge. But there is also an opportunity within this construct in the form of the Henri Jaubert National Piano Competition. How does that slot in, just to raise the nerves, sorry guys, how does that slot into proceedings this year?
Well, the Henri Jaubert was actually started by members from outside Stellenbosch University, but they offered the competition to us a number of years ago and asked us to take it over, which makes perfect sense because the competition is geared towards high school pupils. And incorporating it into the piano symposium gives the participant a taste of what it's like at a university life. And obviously with our facilities, it makes it a lot easier to host it.
It also, again, connects the dots. Chanda, not to make you even more nervous about the fact that you've got to perform alongside your peers and alongside music professors and some of the best exponents, you're also competing out there against some of the best. How do you wrap your head around an opportunity like this? How are you feeling about the symposium and the competition?
Well, I mean, it's a very exciting opportunity to perform in the Henri Jaubert competition. And it's also a very special competition in that it's only for pianists, which isn't very common in many music competitions in South Africa, and it has huge repertoire requirements which are much bigger than what you expect in a lot of other competitions in South Africa. So it is a very exciting opportunity and one of the most exciting competitions that you can do, especially that it happens every 2 years, so it's very exciting to lead up to it.
More time to sit and stew and bubble over how you're going to approach it, because there is such a massive resource to dip into. Reyno, how do you approach, how do you prepare for something like this? Because it's almost like it's a manifestation of where you are as an artist. It's not like you can quickly go and make up the songs and kind of work on the stuff. It represents where you are in your journey. How do you prepare for a weekend like this, for an opportunity like this?
Well, I think you prepare your repertoire on your own, obviously, and then practice efficiently, try to get things done. Obviously, you have university work as well, so you try to balance both.
Try. I like the fact that you said try to balance both. At least that's the true north.
Yeah.
You've got to have
And just to enjoy the music, yeah.
How do you go about selecting the songs for your repertoire? When you talk about the music that you enjoy, that's going to best display your talent. How do you approach that?
I like romantic music, like the romantic era period. So I would always look at composers like Rachmaninoff, Chopin, So I think that really comes easy in my repertoire. So I always choose those pieces, yeah.
And you know, they're like half, no, probably about 9/10 of the country have just rolled their eyes at you because that's the stuff that comes easy. How can we plug into this? How do we get tickets? Maybe, Chanda, I'm going to put it to you, but because you've got to be a proud exponent of what you're doing here at the moment. How do we plug in to see what you guys are doing?
Well, for the Hen U Bar competition for round one and two on April 1st and 2nd, it's free for all observers.
Brilliant.
So, and it's free to watch in the Endler Hall in Stellenbosch. Anybody can come to watch the participants. And for the rest of the piano symposium, there are tickets on available on web tickets, as well as participant and observer passes, which are available.
They're called fans, brother, not observers, fans. Okay, that's, you'll get there, you'll get there when you...
And very important is the website where all the detail is, and that's stellenboschsymposium.com.
Okay, and they do answer back if you've got questions. Connect and find out. This is an opportunity to plug into, as you will see this morning, some of the most, yes, talented, but mind-blowing. People are passing out in studio because of the level of talent here this morning. There is so much opportunity for young artists right now, but they need a platform to put their hand up, and this is that. So we'll keep all of those details up, but most importantly, bring you a first-hand experience. A couple of magical performances coming your way. Don't move.
Well, we said it's a musical Monday, and some have, you know, the passion to create, and some have a passion to support the creatives in a mentorship role.
Yeah, we really do. Now, we're talking about Jikela Studios, which is an NGO in Khayelitsha with the aim of helping musicians manifest their dreams and reach for the stars. I'm absolutely here for this. Let's have a look.
So Jikela Studios is an NPO focused on talent development programs. And our goal or our vision is to build a music school here in Khayelitsha. I started as a DJ myself, and then after being a DJ, I delved into being an artist manager. So I've been an artist manager for almost 15 years, 13 years. And what I see or what I get a lot of young artists coming to me and asking me to manage them. But then I don't have the resources or the funds to do that, man. And I was always thinking, what's the best thing I could do for these kids? And then the idea of the NPO came about. And then that's when I decided, let me open up an NPO with my co-founder, Sipho Fagu. And then I think that's the best way we can assist more artists from the township or underdeveloped communities.
The difference that I believe Jikela Studios has made in Khayelitsha is instill hope that we can indeed all make a small contribution. So our larger aim is to create a creative school, but in the meantime, we've been having boot camps. And what makes it different is that we are showing the success or what we can do in collaboration, the success of that. So it's different in a sense that it's not just an individual school, but a group success. And we are hoping that if we can expand these small efforts, we can make a larger impact than what we already have.
The role we've been playing is really just repurposing our skills and, you know, sharing it and in hopes of the mentees that they are. They have these blind spots of not being able to see their own potential, and it's not enough to see it, but, you know, taking the next step, you know, toward propelling your career. It's not that easy to, you know, to just up and manifest your concept. So I think the part of mentorship, I think it bridges the gap, because then, you know, they get to see how someone else has been able to do it, and it makes it much easier for them to execute with that protection and that nurturing, and to just protect their concepts and affirm in the process and help them to cultivate their ideas.
The teaching and the education that mentees and scholars get from Jikela Studios is significant. Here, the difference is that you put in with creatives that already have a skill, and you must make it work with them. So it's more focused on the group effort.
Collaboration is very important, my man, because we can't do things ourselves. You always need people around you to assist you, because you don't know everything yourself, man. Like, I might know this, but then someone else might know something else. And then if we collaborate, the project becomes more, or we reach more, a wider audience. So I think teamwork and working with each other goes a long way.
Being a mentee on the Chikela Studios program means that you working on like getting as much knowledge as you can, learning your rights as a musician. How is it being on set, making a music video from scratch? It's basically about how to build a whole project. It could be an album, it could be one track, it could be a sequel of tracks, but like it's based on how to build that from scratch, you know, as using the different types of creatives that are involved in a complete project.
I became part of this organization because I saw an opportunity to grow and also to share my skills with others and to also connect with artists locally, because I feel like with the connections that you make with the people, they can take you very far. You never know who's connected to who. So with me being part of this, I started as a graphic design mentee. This year, I want to work on being a mentor and teach other artists and kids who are going to be part of the program to share my skills with them and also give them all the insights that I have when it comes to creativity.
There's too much talent in Khayelitsha. We've got DJs, we've got artists, we've got creators. There's a whole lot of creatives coming out of Khayelitsha at the moment. And the vision is to build the music school in Khayelitsha. And the reason why we want to start in Khayelitsha is because we feel Khayelitsha is the source right now. It's like the creative hub in the city. And obviously you want to branch out to more townships around Cape Town. And then once we get bigger, maybe go to other provinces like the Eastern Cape and Durban. But now we want to start here.
Oh, look at those smiles. Chikela Studios doing some incredible work in the community, and mentorship can bridge the gap between dreams and execution.
Yeah, now that's the mission behind the Chikela Studios NGO. And for more information on the story, you can visit www.chikelastudios.org and you can learn more.
Oh, well, we are taking the quickest of break on your Feel Good Breakfast show. When we get back, we've got 2,000 Rand to give away to one lucky Espresso viewer, so don't go anywhere.
Yeah, and it doesn't stop there, because you're the lucky Espresso viewer, because you get to witness this magician, this mastermind. Look at this talent. We're talking about Gemma Bellini, an absolute stellar SA representative, and she's doing something very interesting that you're going to love to hear more about in just a bit. So don't go anywhere, Mzansi. We'll see you after this.
It's my feel-good breakfast show. Today, we are charging into the world of incredibly talented young people and maybe a sport that you haven't quite connected to yet, fencing, a sport that is often overlooked but harboring incredible talents, physical and mental. And joining us in the studio is a 13-year-old superstar in the making, Gemma Bellini, hailing from the mother city in Cape Town. Now, just last December, she clinched the top spot in the under-15 women's épée category at the Youth National Championship, beat out some of the best. And if that wasn't impressive enough, she went on to secure a very commendable third place at the Junior Africa Games. Ladies and gentlemen, please can you put your hands together for Gemma Bellini? Get used to it, girl, get used to it. Aww. The fans.
Oh. Gemma, so I have to tell you, the first time I saw or understood what fencing was about was in the movie The Parent Trap with Lindsay Lohan. That's probably double your age. But where did your love for fencing come from, and how did you get into it?
Well, when I was like maybe 10, I saw it in like the Olympics. It was like an old video. And I thought, oh, that looked really fun. So then I went to Blues Fencing, and then ever since then.
Oh, wow.
It's intense. It feels like a lot of pressure to put yourself under. There are other sports where you can just chill, you can wait for the ball to come for you, you can do a thing. Fencing, you're on it. The second you're preparing for a bout, what do you call a bout, a fight in fencing?
You do call it a bout.
A bout. Yeah. Wow, I'm winning, I love it. But it requires a very different level of focus, physical ability. How do you train? What does that kind of look like to you? And how much of a role has your family played? Because I would imagine your parents must have been like, hang on a minute, fencing? Are you sure fencing? Fencing, really? With swords, fencing? How do your family fit into this? And how does your training look?
Well, my family is, and Blues Fencing Club is probably my biggest supporters. Yeah. And with training, you kind of just fence everybody. So then you ask somebody, hey, do you want to fence? And then you just like bout up to 5 or 15 points.
Okay.
I love it. Hey, hey, you want a fence?
Do you want a bout?
You want a bout? Let's go.
You're giving away our age. Gemma, this is so exciting. I mean, just hearing what you got up to in December and you know, the achievements you've already achieved. What are your goals leading up to, you know, are you striving to head to the Olympics yourself?
Really?
Yes, I'm striving to, like, win the Olympics one day.
Okay, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, that was pretty impressive.
Yeah, man, you ask a silly question. I mean, come on. I love that. What is it going to take to get you there? Because you are, all due respect, very young. So to have this kind of goal at your age is a very big, powerful thing.
Yeah.
What do you think it's going to require you to do to get that gold medal at the Olympics?
Probably to, like, train lot harder. And probably just overall have, like, a better, like, mentality when it comes to fencing on the piste. So not like focusing on something else, like you're just focusing on fencing.
Mm. For sure.
Yeah, so you just block out all the distractions, the people are yelling, you just block it out in a way.
Go into the zone.
Yeah. Now, when you clinch the top spot at the Youth National Championships, what type of preparation went into that? The type of training, how often did you have to go and prepare yourself for that?
I went every day. Just besides Sunday, yeah.
This is a lot to take in at 13 years old. And I think every parent wants their child to be super focused and be on it and have a passion. What drives your passion? Because I know the Olympics, that's great. That's a great future goal. But right now, you must be getting something from it. Is it the fun that you have? Is it the fact that you get to beat people in the way that you clearly are beating people? What about fencing gives you so much? Why do you love it so much?
I guess it's mostly just the thrill of, like, winning. It's like, it's a kind of feeling that you can't get from anything else. Also, just when you get the adrenaline pumping, it feels like very, very, in a way, like, relaxing.
Mm.
Yeah.
I love that. She's looking at me with a tiger's eye. Like, I'm not challenging you. When I was saying earlier, I want to bounce. It was a joke. Yeah, I was just putting it out there, all right? No, but I love that. I love that level of focus.
I love that. Yeah. Well, Gemma, you said you saw a clip and that's kind of what got you inspired to want to try fencing.
Yeah.
For anyone that perhaps is now watching this, they are maybe 10 years old like you were, and they're like, oh, my word, we love what Gemma's doing. How would you encourage them to give it a try, and what can they maybe expect from it?
Well, you should try, because you'll never know otherwise.
Yeah.
For sure.
Yeah.
I love it, okay? You all start somewhere. And listen, Gemma, as good as she is, hasn't been doing it forever. She's been going at it for a few years and has already achieved all of this, and she's brought in some friends to have a little bit of a bow chair and take us through all of the cool equipment and show us just how really amazing she is at this. I've got to ask you, I hear you also play chess.
Yeah.
Does that help with the fencing?
Yes.
Do you think it kind of helps with the strategy?
It's the exact same strategy, except in fencing you just get poked.
You get poked, or hopefully not. You get to do the poking, but I absolutely love that. I love the fact that there is such a strong mental and physical connection here. Fencing could be the sport that sends you, definitely is going to be the sport that sends Gemma to the Olympics one day, and we're going to get a taste of exactly what that looks like in a bout in just a moment.
I absolutely love that, and I can't wait to see that demo. Gemma, definitely showing us what it's all about and showing us how much you have, I guess, just blossomed, right? And speaking of, children are like flowers. They need proper care to bloom and flourish. And Panado gives you the medication to care for your children, and they're also giving you the chance to win 2,000 Rand in cash. And all you had to do was simply name one of the four additive-free ingredients and tell us why Panado Grape is the clear choice for you as a parent on our Expresso social media pages. And we ask you to use the hashtag #PowerToFightPain and the hashtag PanadoSA. So, it is official. We've sifted through all the hundreds of entries, and we found ourselves another winner. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's put our hands together and congratulate Nalufa Khan! Yes! And an incredible comment, which I'd love to read right now, saying it's alcohol-free. It makes taking medication easier and fun, and Panado is always the clear choice for me and my kids, and don't feel drowsy after taking medication. So happy kids, happy mom, thanks to Panado. And using that hashtag power to fight pain and the hashtag PanadoSA. But I think we've got our winner on the line. Let's say good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
Oh, I'm fantastic. Congratulations. You're a winner. How does it feel?
I'm so overwhelmed. Thank you so much.
Oh, it's an absolute pleasure. Listen, do you love that Panado has added another flavor to their, let's be honest, already extensive range?
Absolutely. You know, I actually ran out of Panado yesterday morning because my daughter plays netball for her school and I had to go and stock up on some more. And I'm so glad to say Panado relieved her pain and fever, and she's stronger for her match tomorrow morning.
Oh, Nalufa, this obviously makes my heart smile. Thank you for sharing that with us. And I got to say, you obviously now, if you aren't aware, are 2,000 Rand richer. What are you going to do with the money?
Oh, my God.
any good plans on spending that cash?
Yes, this is such a beautiful blessing, as this will not only enable me to stock up one more Panado, but it will also enable me to obtain my learner's and driver's license.
Oh, wow. That is absolutely incredible. Well, Nalufa, thank you so much for being a part of this competition. Again, congratulations and good luck with the rest of those tests to unlock your ability to travel freely along the roads.
Thank you so much.
You can see just how much it means to this winner, and that could be you as well. But again, congratulations to our lucky winners thus far. I want you, though, to tune in tomorrow because we still have two winners to announce, and it might just be you.
New Panado Grape Flavor Syrup. Colorant, tartrazine, alcohol, and sugar-free. Giving you the power to fight their pain in a new flavor that is great. I mean, grape. It's a clear choice in fast pain and fever relief.
I know I said it's a musical Monday, now I feel it's a motivational Monday. The youth is coming through with all of their talents. We have Gemma Bellini, who's going to show us a little bit about what her fencing skills is all about. And then we have Maggie in studio. Normally it's her mom wearing the apron, but today Maggie is going to show us how to make these delicious puff pastry nests perfect ahead of the Easter weekend. So don't go anywhere. Maggie is ready to put all of these wonderful ingredients together for us. Only you can make my
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Welcome back, you beauties. We promised you talent in spades, and we have it this morning. We are really honored to have some remarkable young, talented stars in studio, very much embodied by fencer Gemma Bellini, who's back on our little stage here. This time, she is not just chatting. I'm going to take a step away. She is going to give us a first-hand demonstration of her incredible fencing skills, and hopefully will teach us a little bit along the way. But of course, you aren't in this little family team alone. We're going to bring in more Bellinis if we can. You've got your sister Stella here.
Yes.
Help Stella get in here when you are ready. So first of all, what I'd like to ask is what you are wearing. Talk us through the incredibly cool equipment that you get to utilize while you're fencing.
So this is the blade. Okay. This is basically the entire game right here. And then, so it has a pistol grip, which is how you hold it, just like this.
Ooh.
This
can
over
I,
here.
Can I yeah. give it a hold? Do you mind? Right Thank there. You for being so... Ooh, check how she likes. She's not letting it go. Not a chance. Wow. It's almost like a little gun type handle.
Yes.
Hey? Ooh, I like that.
There you go.
There we go. Safety then, first.
Over here's a plug, which plugs right. So you have like a long body wire usually, and that will plug into a machine behind you. And then when you press the point right here, that is how the point will register.
Ooh, I love that. So there is absolutely no disputing it. Stella! We need Stella to join us here. So you're going to talk us through and walk us through a little bit of a demonstration. Stella, welcome to the fold. So good to have you here as well. You guys must be so proud of each other. How cool is it to see your sister doing what she is doing at the moment?
It's really cool.
It's really cool because you get to do it as well. I love it. Okay, so talk us through a common situation when you guys enter into a bout. How does that play out?
So first you have your footwork.
Okay.
So footwork's also very, very important. So it's quite a, so it's like this kind of stance with this amount of space. There you go. Straighten that back foot. And then you go much, much lower.
All right.
There you go. With your arm bent, with a fist in between. Just like that.
Right. I'm going to pop this down. Just suddenly become a southpaw, but it's okay.
Yes. And then that's how you fend. So this is a step. So you step forward, step backwards.
No chuckling. I can hear the chuckling going on behind me.
And then you get a lunge. Yes, there we go. And then you extend your back arm to keep the balance.
I love it. Oh, it's not like my legs are exhausted at all from the weekend. No, I love that, and I love the fact that that simple process plays out at such high speed.
Yeah.
So maybe give us a little bit of a demonstration here so we can see it in action. Obviously, safety equipment is paramount when you're moving this fast and you are holding... What do you officially call the blade, effectively, that you're holding?
This is called an épée.
Épée.
You get three weapons. Epe, foil, and saber. Each of them have different rules.
Okay, brilliant.
Yeah.
Okay, ladies, take it away.
So first you have a bind parry. So Stella's going to extend. Then I'm going to take, step through.
That's when we hear the beep.
Then Stella's going to extend again. This is called a parry. So you're taking the blade, making sure it can't hit you, then you hit. Then Stella's going to extend again. Okay, now this one is gonna extend a little bit lower. Then you take this parry and step. So you get binds and parries.
I love that. And of course, this is all playing out at literally microsecond speed. How many points do you get to score in one session? How does a battle normally play out?
So usually you'll have pulls, which are 5 points each bout. And then you have DEs, which if you make it through to DEs, you fence for 15 points.
Sure. Can you give us a little taste here? Can you do a little demo?
Sure.
Great. So, he asks, but he steps away.
It won't register any points because you have nothing clicked into.
Right, we'll try and decide ourselves. Ooh, very, very sneaky. I feel like I should be making the beep noise. Nice. So far, Stella's holding her own. Oh, and Big Sis sneaks one through. Oh, I feel like she set her up for that one. Oh, I love it. I'm going to let the last point win it. Oh, I absolutely love that. Thank you so much, Stella. Thank you so much for coming along. I love the fact that there is so much focus in the space. Where do you look? What do you focus on when you're fencing?
Well, you really focus on everything.
On everything. You take it all in. I love the fact that the mind is working, that the body is working. I love the fact that this is a family affair. Expect big things from this gene pool. It is incredible to see what you can achieve with the mental focus matched with the physical preparation. And I think fencing has the best of everything. And clearly this family has got that in spades. If you are interested, reach out. We'll keep the resources up on all of our social media platforms. If you too have the goal of making it to the Olympics and getting that gold, fencing has one of the proudest traditions in sport, and we have the opportunity to plug right in here in SA, and great exponents to drive that forward. Thank you so much, ladies. Well done. Absolutely amazing.
Well, the next recipe we're about to make is probably not the best thing to eat in your white fencing outfit, because get ready to create the essence of indulgence with these vibrant puff pastry Easter nests, layered with chocolate spread and decorated to perfection. With Easter literally around the corner, we are joined by our young chef today, Maggie, who's going to show us how you can really add a lot of fun to this delicious dish. Maggie, I'm so excited that we get to be in the kitchen today. How much do you love Easter?
A lot.
You love it a lot. Yeah. What is your favorite thing about Easter?
I don't know, the Easter eggs.
The Easter eggs, yes, the chocolate, the deliciousness, and
speckled eggs.
The speckled eggs, for sure. Now, we're about to create these beautiful puff pastry nests. Now, we've got some puff pastry in front of us. Are you going to start off by just putting some of the chocolate spread for us onto our puff pastry? You can go for it. I mean, this is a really fun recipe. You can play around with your spread. Perhaps chocolate's not your thing. You maybe want more of a white chocolate or caramel. This really is a fun recipe. Now, when you cook, you have to be honest. How much of the ingredients do you end up tasting?
Half.
Half of it? Me too, me too. That's how I used to love helping my mom in the kitchen cook. Now, is cooking something that you want to maybe pursue one day when you are older?
Yeah.
Is it? Okay. Are you going to go the sweet route or the savory route?
Both.
Both. Okay. Okay. I love this. Okay. So we are getting our chocolate spread on. You're being way too... we need to get... You know what? This is our recipe. We can add more chocolate spread. Definitely, definitely. That's the nice thing when you start cooking for yourself. You add all the things you like. I like chocolate, so we can add more. I think just go for it. Okay. There we go. How old were you the first time you tried making this recipe?
Five, maybe four.
Okay, so this is a recipe that you are now quite seasoned in. So we'll get the chocolate spread in there. We've got Ryle that also wants to come and join us and see how the magic happens.
Maggie, Kay. What's happening? How are you doing? High fives. Oh, yeah.
There
are we doing
go.
It on what are we making, by the way?
We are making some puff pastry nests.
Okay, I just heard Maggie was spreading chocolate somewhere, and I was like, okay, I'm in. Bring me in here. Is this something
perfect.
You get to do with your mom a lot?
Sometimes, yeah.
Sometimes? Or does she just steal all the good stuff away from you in the kitchen?
No.
Not
at all.
Okay, all right. So I wanted to find out exactly how many of these we're going to make, because there's a lot of people looking around you salivating at this idea, and I think we've got like 30 people? Do you think
we have got quite
30?
A few people? So what I'll do is I'll
have to cut
small
pieces.
Maggie, do you want to show us how we can maybe get our little puff pastries into the nest? Are we going to do that together?
We can each take one.
We can each take one. So Ryle, we're going to get you involved here. Let me just
wash up a little bit.
Naturally,
better
you will cut them in straight lines and get as many as possible. I will grab this one.
Maggie, I'm like the worst in the kitchen, so you're going to have to help me a lot here, all right?
I'm going to hand you this one, Ryle.
Thank you so much. Got it.
There we go. Did I not cut so well?
So what exactly am I doing with this?
Get in there quickly with the knife. There we go.
Okay, Maggie, so what, do I put it over my head like this, or do I make... What do I do with it?
You got to twist one side this way and one side that way.
Okay.
Okay, so you do a little bit of a twist.
Oh, okay. Got you.
Okay, wait, I'm joining in. So we just do a little bit of a twisty.
Okay. Like that? You happy? Do you approve?
Yeah.
Okay, if Maggie approves, then this is good.
Twisted.
Yeah, no. How did you get it? How did you get it like that?
Just
what are you doing differently? I don't know. It's
maybe twisting.
Maybe
and
it's
then
the,
yeah. How do we get it into the nest? The little nest.
And roll it.
Okay. Oh, so we need to roll it into a little circle while it's twisted.
And then we'll put them on the tray.
So we'll pop these onto our baking tray, and then for how long do these go into the oven?
15 to 20 minutes.
15 to 20 minutes. Our beautiful puff pastry. We'll pop all of these into the oven. When it comes out, it will look like that. Now, we want to obviously decorate our nest. So we've got some chocolate mousse and your favorite, the speckled eggs. Although I'm only seeing four eggs, so I don't know if...
Did someone get to your favorites?
Who
ate your favorites?
Who was it?
All right, so how do we do this part? Because this is probably the best part and the fun part about it, because now we get to get our favorites. I think if I had a favorite, I would maybe choose like a jelly tot, but... This is a winner. I've never thought about putting something like this on.
But that's the beauty of this recipe.
Yeah.
It's you can really play along. So Maggie's favorite is speckled eggs.
Nice.
You like jelly tots. I love jelly tots.
I think that's better
can
than jelly tots.
Put it on for you.
It's like jelly tots with nice. Jelly tots with like a candy coating. So I think you win on the creativity, choosing the best stuff to go on top of it.
Fantastic.
Very nice.
There we go. Oh, what I forgot to mention is before we pop our beautiful little nest into the oven, we just give it a quick little egg wash.
Oh, yeah.
And then it will give it that beautiful golden color. Maggie, I love this. I absolutely love this. So now I feel like it's only fair that the two of you taste your delicious creations.
It's
so,
our favorite part.
I mean, did you ever think you would eat a little Easter chocolate puff pastry nest for breakfast?
No.
All right, so I think we should do a Easter chocolate nest cheers. And then how do we eat this? Do I take a
you
bite or the whole thing
nice
in the mouth?
Bite.
What are you going to do?
No.
We've got to make decisions
TV
here.
TV bites are
okay, let's
smaller.
Take a TV bite. I don't think the whole thing's going to fit.
A TV bite. Oh, Ryle's going in there. Mm. You know, the thing is, kids are honest. Kids never lie. So you need to give us your honest feedback. Mm-hmm. What do you think of our puff pastry little nest?
Really good.
Oh, see? It's really, really good.
I agree. Well done.
Maggie, you were amazing. Thank you for showing us this delicious recipe. If you want to get your hands on it, it is available on our website, expressoshow.com. I am now dubbing these Maggie's Puff Pastry Egg Nests. So there we go. Go and get that recipe and try it out for yourself. And we will see you in just a bit because I also feel like I need to have one for breakfast. Yeah. Okay. You can make my day.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
thing is we are celebrating incredibly talented young people. We thought we'd ask, well, our resident model, Jaylee, to step in and show us what she actually gets up to over the weekends. Winning lots and lots of gold medals by the looks of it. Yes, we're going to get into karate as an incredible discipline that will, I think, activate your child in so many incredible ways. She's going to show us how it's done on the other side of this.
Thank you so much. Yes, it's 2 minutes to the hour, but official duties must commence, and starting with the national news headlines. Now, the National Sea Rescue Institute, otherwise known as the NSRI, said yesterday afternoon that the charter ski boat Magnum 2, belonging to missing skipper John Matambu, had been found wrecked and presumably gutted by fire. Now, NSRI spokesperson Craig Lampinon said that during an extensive search involving multiple agencies and a fixed-wing aircraft, the Magnum 2 was found near Dobela on the Mozambique coastline yesterday. Now, Lampinon said there were no signs of skipper John Matambu or an as-yet unidentified man who reportedly chartered the fishing vessel. Now, a missing persons report has been opened by the police. Now, carrying on with national headlines, a 32-year-old woman has been arrested in connection with the disappearance of 6-year-old Jocelyn Smith from Sultana Bay on the Cape West Coast. Now, this after police earlier said more people were taken in for questioning as part of the investigation. Now, last week, three accused, including the child's mother, appeared in court. Now, the search for the little girl, however, continues. And she went missing from her home in the Middelpos informal settlement on 19th of Feb. And the latest suspect is expected to appear in the Vredenburg Magistrates Court today. Well, moving over to international headlines, and German Chancellor Olaf Scholz has criticized Israel's plans for a full-scale offensive in the southern city of Rafah. But Israel previously defended its plans, saying they were necessary to bring an end to Hamas in the Strip. And Israel's Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu said the following with a quote: "No international pressure will stop Israel from achieving all of its war aims." Now, meanwhile, the first aid shipment to Gaza contained 200 tons of food, including rice, oil and dates. Now, the mission was carried out by the U.S. charity World Central Kitchen in cooperation with the United Arab Emirates. Well, next up in our headlines, widespread internet outages were reported on Thursday in countries including SA, Nigeria, Ivory Coast, Liberia and Ghana. Now, since then, services have largely been restored in Liberia and South Africa. Now, the cause of the cable failures was not immediately clear, and much to the frustration of millions of customers around the continent. Now, there seems to be a pattern in the timing of the disruptions impacting from the north to the south of Africa, and this being said by Cloudflare Radar, which provides information on internet connections. Now, a retired expert said sometimes undersea cables do get cut, and even by debris. Lastly in our headlines, lipstick enthusiasts are in for a delightful surprise as a recent study reveals that the world's oldest known lipstick, worn some 5,000 years ago in southeast Iran, has been unearthed. Now, this enchanting deep red lip paint nestled in a stone vial was discovered at an ancient graveyard site. Now, unlike our modern day lipsticks, this ancient beauty essential was likely delicately applied with a brush, and this being said by a team of international scientists. Now, Massimo Vidale, a professor of archaeology at Italy's University of Padua, shared his whimsical vision of it probably being worn by the women of the elite societies of 5,000 years ago. However, Iran's contemporary theocracy casts a weary eye on such charming cosmetic traditions. Well, an interesting tale nonetheless, and we dive into all the history of this with our minds, but we've got history being made right now when it comes to sport. And G-Man, of course, has the latest.
It's cup competition time, and in a pulsating FA Cup quarterfinal yesterday, Manchester United dashed Liverpool's hopes of a quadruple this season with Amad Diallo's decisive goal in a thrilling 4-3 victory. That was after extra time. So Eric Ten Hag's side, they mounted two late comebacks, overcoming Liverpool's lead twice. Scott McTominay opening the scoring for before goals from Alexis McAllister and Mohamed Salah then put Liverpool back ahead. Then Anthony's equaliser forced extra time, where Harvey Elliott restored Liverpool's lead. However, Marcus Rashford levelled the score once again before Diallo sealed United's win in added time of extra time. Incredible. Talk about Fergie time. St. Coventry City in the semi-finals is what awaits them at Wembley, and that's on the weekend of the 20th and the 21st of April. Incredible stuff. Now we turn to rugby, and Ireland clinched their Six Nations title with a hard-fought 17-13 victory over Scotland at Lansdowne Road on Saturday. Tries from Dan Sheehan and Andrew Porter proved decisive as the hosts encountered some stiff resistance from Scotland's formidable defence throughout the match. In fact, throughout the tournament they've been on it, and although denied the chance for a historic Grand Slam, of course, following last weekend's defeat to England, Ireland's consecutive title triumphs echoing the incredible achievements of Joe Schmidt's side back in 2014 and 2015. Now let's bring it back to the continent and the African Games. And Team South Africa kicked off their African Games campaign in style when we turned to cricket as they dominated the hosts Ghana with a commanding 134-run victory at the Achimota Cricket Oval yesterday. Captain George Van Heeren, he led the charge with a magnificent maiden T20 century, scoring an unbeaten 107 runs of just 57 deliveries. And on the way there, 8 fours and 7 sixes. South Africa posting an imposing total of 237 for 2 after opting to bat first, clearly the right choice. And Ghana, well, they struggled to get going in their chase, managing only 103 for 7. Team South Africa is set now to face Kenya today at that same venue, obviously looking to extend that winning streak. Now, speaking of which, world number one Scottie Scheffler made history by becoming the first player to secure back-to-back victories at the Players' Championship with a remarkable 8-under-par 64 yesterday, clinching a one-stroke triumph at the TPC Sawgrass Wyndham Clark. Brian Harman and Xander Schauffele also finishing just one shot behind Scheffler, with Clark narrowly missing a playoff opportunity after his birdie attempt on the 18th hole just scuffed off and left ruining what could have been a massive opportunity. But that's where we leave our sport for this hour of the show. The roads should be up and running. Let's get you to work safely.
Thanks, G-Man. Well, let's start off with traffic in Johannesburg. There's some protesting taking place on the N1 northbound at Diepkloof Interchange, causing delays. Please make use of an alternative route to avoid any delays. And if you're in Milnerton, Cape Town, there's congestion on the N7 south at Bosman's Dam Ramp. Expect delays and allow for more travel time. That's your traffic. Let's take another look at your weather. And news on matters water this morning is that the woes of Rand Water seem to be continuing. This, as Johannesburg Water says, the water supply is under great pressure due to the high temperatures experienced and the lack of rain in the recent weeks. Spokesperson Nombuso Shabalala says that even though Rand Water supplies the normal amounts of water, storage dams cannot maintain capacity. She urgently appealed to Johannesburg residents to comply with level 1 water restrictions and reduce water wastage by at least 10%. The Tshwane Metro Council issued a similar warning yesterday, and some water supply points have already been closed. If you would love to share your morning view with us, do so on our WhatsApp line. That number is 063-408-8863, and we have one to share with you right now. Tacy from St. Helena Bay shared this majestic view. Look at the water, the birds, and of course the sun rising in the distance. That is a gorgeous video, well, photo. If you would love to share yours, do so on our WhatsApp line. But it's time for us to take a look at your temperatures for today.
to show. You almost just want to douse it on your head. Douse it on your head.
Oh, well done, gentlemen. So what's coming up on the show?
Mm-hmm. Ooh, a lot of highlights, I think, with regards to, obviously, the youngsters that are on the show. I mean, there's a lot to look forward to. But before we even talk about that, I know you guys had a good weekend because you came in here with big smiles. I want to know
big
what
smiles
those big
smiles and exhausted bodies, man. Yeah. Let's delve into our weekend highlights. And I feel awful because I'm like a massive undersharer when it comes to my family.
Yeah, man.
I know, I'm sorry, man. I'm sorry, but you've got to have your own little space. But I'm just so unbelievably proud of my little man. We had the most amazing weekend. Yesterday, we literally conquered the mountain. So we've been kind of going up and down.
Whoa, scrambling here, bro.
Yeah, dude. Ooh. Right to the actual summit. We ran
out
of path.
Beacon, yeah.
And it wasn't going to slow him down. And we made it all the way to the very peak of Constantia Neck, which was the most incredible thing.
That's amazing.
So much higher than I think he thought he could do. Just incredible. Look at that. And of course, enjoying our donut prize up at the top, because you've got to have a little mini donut.
You have
top
to
of the mountain. But,
that's Eagle's Nest, right? Incredible viewpoint.
Just, and the eagles were out, and it was the most amazing thing. So many moments. It took us about 2 hours to get up to the top, and just about as long. But I've got to say that as we're coming down there, there's fully grown, fit adults sweating, trying to make it up that first third, which is like
that's
looking at the six-year-old coming down, like, oh, my word, what's wrong with me? So, so awesome. Little man, I'm so proud of you.
A young nature boy,
incredible.
Bro.
Incredible. You would have been so proud.
I would.
I am proper proud. Rock climbing and, awesome, man.
I am proud, man. That is awesome stuff. Look, my one was very, very, very busy. I had a very, very busy weekend. I did almost everything that you could. Friday was waves, so we got to surf, which is amazing.
Thanks for the pictures at like 7 a.m. half of our cameramen are like, why are you doing this to us, Raul?
But it was so good. I got to have a session with Shawnee as well, one of our cameramen. He came out at a double session Friday. So it was absolutely just incredible to have the cup filled. And I'm learning more and more as I'm trying to log and venture towards the nose. So it's just so exciting to be humbled by this. Call it a sport or activity, but at the same time, just to have so much fun with it, man. Learning so much constantly as I get out there and just trying to make the most of it.
That's and then, really cool.
Yeah, it's become fun. I can start like walking on the board now, so it's getting a little bit
better. Clearly, dude.
Yeah, we're getting slowly better. Yeah. So, thanks to Shawnee, our cameraman. Shout out to you, bro. Man's it's been inspiring. And then that same evening, my cup was filled and I got the honor of being an MC for Bass. I don't know if you know Sebastian Heeman, one of our producers. So, you had a cover reveal for Man Magazine. Look how sexy this light is. Wow, I was so impressed with him. So that took the activities all the way into the evening, and it was just really cool to see Bass just being represented and acknowledged for the work he puts in. Yeah, and then it was straight from there, early morning, we did Gaia. Straight after Gaia, we hosted something in the forest, and then I had a great paddle game with some incredible paddle players as well. So super busy weekend, cycled to for ice cream with Mal afterwards, and then we hosted a workshop at Big Bay for some of the kids that are going to SA Champs. So it's like crunch time now.
Proper life-saving vibes.
Life-saving SA Champs. It was really awesome. So absolutely busy weekend. Jeez, I'm like
where
just
where did you
breathing.
Get your energy from?
I don't know. I think I'm fueled by
you're like adopting other people's kids. Wait till you've got your own kids and then you'll see. Maybe
Boss Jackie, I'll take
maybe
the
at the end of this,
bro.
I'll show you what a parent's face should really look like. Okay, and that wasn't even at the end of the weekend, beginning of the weekend. What did you get up to?
We had a busy weekend, so our place is on the market. So with viewings, that meant we couldn't be home. So we literally got home and there was still one final viewing going on. So we're like, hung out. Even Navy came outside. She was like, okay, why are so many strangers?
Did you loiter outside your own house?
We loitered at the behind, like, just so that we all, like, look at that. We were all waiting. Even Navy came out. She's like, I'm done with this. Can we have our house back?
Oh, her face captures it perfectly.
Yeah, but it was a beautiful weekend. Family, obviously, trickling in. We had a family lunch yesterday with Robbie's side of the family, which was quite lovely,
nice
in Hout Bay. And then my sister's arriving today, so I'm just looking forward to some quality time with family. There's a wedding in our family happening, so despite all the challenges, we are all looking really forward to just everyone
being together.
These
are special
times. Oh, and something else I'm doing is I'm cleaning out my cupboard. So I've been putting up all my old dresses on Yuggas, and it's sold immediately. So for me, it's just been like a lot of fun getting other people to just get more joy out of clothing that I'm no longer wearing.
Do you remember all these things you were wearing? She forgot.
I do. I remember exactly what outfit I bought for when.
Because there's always a moment,
like, clearing out my cupboard.
Each outfit.
And there's always people asking me, like, Zoe, where can we get your dresses? So now you can get the dresses.
Go check it out at Yoga, guys. That's the plug.
And of course, you've been training like a machine.
Getting
the
there.
So well done.
Baby
man.
Steps, not Raul's level, but my level.
Oh, that's impressive. This is amazing. Guys, we're having stellar weekends.
Well done.
Very nice.
I've got to ask, because my beautiful wife gifted one particular photo from this weekend. I don't know if you've got it, but
that's what a dad looks like after
a full day, my friend. Just soak
that's
that up.
That's a great sight to see, man.
Baby, I love you. Thank you so much for taking that photo just to make sure that was there. But Friday was a killer day. You don't joke
again. What time was that?
It could have been about 5 o'clock in the afternoon.
Look, that for me is a highlight. Seeing you get a chance to rest. You deserve that. You earned it. I think we all did. So I think cheers to that, guys. Well done on an incredible weekend. I think something that we all get to really cherish, especially considering how hard we work in the week, how much we're juggling. And I hope you, Mzansi, get to do the exact same thing. Make the most of the blessings that you have and the beautiful vessel that you've been blessed with. Mm. Now, speaking of blessings, we've got lots more blessings coming in your Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Of course, we've got Jay Lee, one of our resident models, who is modeling the perfect behavior as a karateka. She has got her gi on and looking inspired and inspiring. We're going to connect you to her and then some incredible musicians as well.
Yeah, Janda's coming through. It's going to be an exceptional performance. So, Mzansi, you have every reason to not go anywhere. We'll see after this.
Yes, Mzansi, welcome back to your Feel Good Breakfast Show. And let me just welcome you to your couch. Sit tight and get ready to meet the extraordinary Jay Lee Jacolia Hesqua. Yes, a dynamic young girl who thrives on challenges and embraces her passions with gusto. Now, from her love for the environment to her dedication to karate, Jay Lee's story is nothing short of inspiring. But before we even get to chat to her, let's get a big feel good.
Jay Lee, what
What's happening? How are you doing?
Good.
Don't act surprised. You know us. You know the show. You know we're going to be a little bit silly because we're so excited that you're so awesome. Obviously, we've been able to see you doing your modeling thing and having a lot of fun, just being an awesome kid. And we want our kids to be kids. But we also love it when our kids show us a glimpse of who they're going to become. And I get the sense, the energy, the vibe you're giving off, because you've only just started your karate journey. Big things, girl. Big, big things. But it all has to start with that first step or that first kia. Where did that begin? Oh, I didn't mean to engage there. And did you see the eyes there? I was like, oh, sorry.
Careful now.
Where did this start? Why karate? Why was that the thing that just grabbed you?
Because I wanted, like, because even when I started creche, there was, like, lots of children, like teasing me.
Really?
So I wanted to, like, I forgot about them. But then also I just wanted to, like, get some power.
Be strong. Oh, get your power.
It. And protect myself, my friends, and my family from the ones that bullies them.
I love that.
Nice. That is such an honorable cause. I love what you're doing. Now, you said you wanted to get your power.
Yeah.
Did you find your power? Was it hard to find your power? Was it quite challenging to get into karate?
No, I just had to, like, focus really hard. Even my sensei said I was really disciplined.
So focus and discipline, that's something special that you have. Oh, okay, I'm gonna start try a little bit of that.
I love that, but it's you never stop a journey in karate. For the rest of your life, you'll be learning. So we get great achievements, clearly the gold medals, and that's fun to have, but it requires a lot of work. How do you keep yourself focused and strong? How do you get yourself into that mode?
So when karate starts and school's over, I will just, like, go into karate mode and focus on that. And then when that's done, I can, like, rest.
Nice. So you said you go into, like, karate switched mode.
On.
So do you have a Jay Lee school mode as well? Jay Lee homework mode? Or is it all the same person?
It's the same person.
Okay, so then you're the same person, but you have to juggle all these things. And already at such an age, you're busy, busier than some of the busy old people that I know. How do you do that? How do you keep the discipline from karate with you when you are in school? Do you use the same system?
No, I don't. I will focus in school, yes, but I won't use, like, discipline. I would rather focus, and then when it's playtime, then I will, like, let it all out. And
let it all out.
I like that. Okay.
I love that. That's great. Clearly, you've learned a lot about yourself through this journey, which, I mean, it takes a lot of us a long time. I'm sure Ryle, as an athlete, is still learning about
still
himself.
Learning.
And how his body is gradually degrading the older daughter. but you must have learned some really cool things about yourself, especially in a competition when you actually are in a kumite or doing one of your katas. What are you most proud of about yourself?
I'm most proud of that most of the gold medals are because of my kata.
Oh, really? What's your favorite kata?
Hanshoran.
Hein Shoran.
The first kata.
The first kata.
Do you maybe want to explain to people that don't know what a kata is and what that is that you're talking about? Could you maybe show us, perhaps?
Yeah, a kata is when, like you do. So you do karate, but you do it, like, in a group.
Sure.
So you do.
You do your form.
Whoa, careful now. Whoa, buddy. Gee, are you okay?
I'm glad you...
Whoa! Yeah. Hey! Ayah!
Yeah. Yeah.
Nice.
Woo!
You don't understand. She's busy re-choreographing her kata to do it in a very limited space.
Well done.
And listen, she was able to kind of maneuver in this space in a very tight kind of environment, which speaks to you having a deep understanding of what you're doing. If you can really take that on board, I love it. What's the goal here? Are we talking, let's go all the way, world championship title? Do you just want to learn more? What do you want out of your karate?
So I just want to learn, and, like, I want to learn because I want to detect, and I just want to learn.
So you can protect?
Yes.
Oh, that is an admirable cause. Listen, you are someone that I think even us older people are being inspired by. So thank you for bringing your energy here. And I think that there's a lot of old people and, more importantly, kids watching you right now that are thinking, whoa, Jaylee's amazing. I want to do what she's doing. She's doing schoolwork. She's a karate superstar. How do I become like her? And how do I get to her level? Do you have any tips,
maybe some advice? I know you're young, but you're clearly doing something right so far. So what advice do you maybe have for some youngsters trying to do what you're doing?
So they should probably first like get into karate, then they mustn't play around, they must just focus the entire time.
Brilliant advice.
Can you show us how the finger works? Focus.
Focus. I love it. Focus.
You use the words with that one. You are wonderful. Thank you so much. I know we've gotten to know you quite well over the last few years, but I feel like we're being reintroduced to you. So impressive. So proud of you, girl. Keep it up. We love it. If you are this proud of your child, foster that in them. They might go a very different route when they are older, but being able to apply themselves like this, with that kind of focus, this kind of energy, and most importantly, passion and enjoyment, they will head to the stars, whatever that looks like. But we are so proud of you, girl. Thank you so much for being here this morning.
You're welcome.
Oh, well, we are keeping the motivation going because you're in for a treat as we get back-to-back performances. First up is Chanda Lupambo. He is taking the stage right now. And then Nina Schumann will be joining him for the second performance. Ladies and gentlemen, enjoy.
Hi, I'm Chanda Lupambo, and I will be performing Rachmaninoff's Etude, Opus 39, number 1.
Absolutely wow. Beautiful. The Piano Symposium happening at Stellenbosch University. 3rd to the 7th of April this year. You can get your tickets at Web Tickets. Many of the elements are actually free for all observers. As Chanda said earlier, I'm going to call them fans to go and watch, but an opportunity to clearly see some of the best in the business at work, and they ain't going nowhere. We've got a few more performances.
Yeah, more performances coming at you and more delicious stuff. We're diving into the kitchen after this. We've got something in the lines of like spiced crumble. We've got peaches. There's wheat involved. It sounds delicious, and I can't wait for you to dive into it and look at that. Oh,
with custard,
get in
baby.
My belly.
And then, of course, Jaylee is going to give us a little demonstration of some of those karate skills and that karate mindset. Oh, I'm sorry, Ryle. She's coming for you, bud. Coming. We'll see for that after this.
Are you auditioning and getting ready for Tropica Island of Treasure? Well, don't let joint and muscular pain hold you back. Deep Eat is your go-to warm-up solution and SA's number one choice.
Oh, yes, and here's an extra incentive. The top 7 contestants heading to the island will each receive 10,000 Rand from Deep Eat. And remember, you can upload your audition with the hashtag Deep Eat and the hashtag Tropica and tag My Tropica.
Who knows, you could be competing in Zanzibar.
Yeah, it's time to reach your full potential.
Get Deep Eat and conquer the island.
It's my feel-good breakfast show. All right, Mzansi, welcome back. Yes, this is your feel-good breakfast show. Welcome to it. And let me prepare you to be prepared by someone that is absolutely incredible. Yes, they're going to amaze you. They go by the name of Jaylee Jacolia, and they are a rising star in the world of karate. And it's time to take center stage right now and show off some impressive skills and the numerous accolades that Jaylee has accomplished. Now, she's ready to showcase the power and precision that's defining her martial arts journey. We've spoken to her on the couch. Now, let's see what she's all about. Now, Jaylee, before we get into anything, I just wanted to find out exactly. It looks like you've got an orange belt here, right?
Yeah.
Is this something that you sort of have to unlock or earn?
Yeah, it is. So, when how to earn your belt is that you must focus, like I said, on the couch. And you must, so they will, like, ask you, there's a day that all the categories of the belts will earn a new belt and move higher.
Okay.
And when you get black belt, then you can teach the whole class.
Whoa, do you want to get a black belt one day?
Yes.
Okay, so these are the things that you're going to show us now, this demo, is something you need to do in order to get these belts, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so explain to me exactly what you're going to be doing now.
So I'm going to do being a kata.
A kata.
A kata is when, like, you do, like, the moves, like I showed you. But also, it's about the focus.
Okay, so you're going to show us how to do the moves, show us the focus, and put it all together right here on live TV. So take it away. I'm going to let you do your thing, and I'm going to stand out the way so I don't get hurt here. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Jay Lee with her kata. Stage is yours.
And children! Jay!
Nice.
Jay!
Wow, well done. That was amazing. Wow, I got a bit intimidated there, actually. So I know this is stuff that you have to learn and practice and really work on, but is there any way you can maybe just teach me one of those moves and what they're called? Because I just, even one of those like little stances that you have, it sounds amazing. Can you teach me something?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, what do you want to show me?
So this is Agiyuki.
Say it again?
Agiyuki.
Agiyuki. Okay, so you're standing left foot forward and then?
And Agiyuki.
Agiyuki. Okay, let's do that again. So we go, step one, we go. One, two. Agiyuki! Yes, okay, okay. So is this a move that you'd use to fight, defend yourself, or a bit of both?
Yeah, this is the simple moves that you have to learn to become actually black belt. So even now that you're black belt, you still need to know this.
Okay.
Or else when you go to competitions, then when they try to kick you too high, then you can just like block.
Like block it like this. Okay, yes. So
or
that's
even a punch, when they're gonna punch you, then you can just block.
Oh, nice. How would you, I saw you did a quite an interesting punch where you used your foot as well. What is that called, do you know?
I mean this.
Yeah.
I can't remember, but I do know that's also one of the basics.
Okay, so maybe you can teach me, how do you do that exactly? Because you've got a nice strong stance.
And take back.
Oh, so you bring in that from the top and you, wow.
There you go.
Wow.
So from the ear, then you go down.
Okay. So you actually get more power when you're coming from the ear like that as well.
Yeah.
Okay, all right. I'm absolutely loving this. Now, I believe you've won quite a few medals in your day, right? I was reading something like 20 golds
yeah,
or nine. 20. How many is it in total?
20.
20 in total, whoa. So we're quite lucky because apparently we actually have your medals on display. So I'm seeing a lot of shining medals over there. Do you want to talk to me? Let's go over here and actually, I'm impressed with this. Can I first say, well done. You are so young and already it looks like you're taking over the world. But which of these are your favorite? Because I know there's so many here, all the way from like 2023. So this is just from the last year only.
Yes, only.
Wow.
This is only like 3 years.
Sorry, excuse me. So which is like one of your favorite? What are the big medals here for you that stand out?
I really like the gold.
Okay, let's show the camera the gold there so they can see as well.
I like this one.
Whoa, okay.
The big one and then this tiny one.
And where did you earn that for? Where was that for?
This one.
Yeah.
That was like last week. I just did my competition and then I won.
Last week?
Yes.
So this is the freshest one. Well done. Well, Zanzi, clearly we are all inspired, taken away by the young talent that we have here on your Feel Good Breakfast show right now. And let me just say, you are an absolutely incredible athlete. I can't wait to see you wearing that black belt, and I think it's going to be soon. But thank you so much for coming on the show, for inspiring a lot of South Africa, and also showing all your incredible talent as
thank
well.
Thank you for welcoming me.
Oh, it was an absolute pleasure. This is the one and only future black belt superstar, and I'm telling you, you want to keep your eyes on this one. This is Jay Lee Son, watch out. Thanks for teaching me those moves.
Oh, you are a natural. That was so, so special. And I love all your medals. Well, we're about to be in the kitchen and I'm yet to win a medal for my cooking. But when it comes to custard, I don't need a medal for that because it comes with every box. Now, when we found out that Clover just launched their brand new vanilla flavored custard, we had to whip up the perfect dessert that can be smothered in this creamy gold. And this morning we are making some grilled peaches with a spiced almond crumble, wow. And we're going to serve it with as much custard as possible. In fact, it's up to you to decide how much custard you would want. So G-Man,
all of the custard. We want all of the custard this morning.
As much as the bowl can hold. How's that for a compromise?
I love it. I love the fact that what would normally be a side almost becomes the body of the dessert
yes.
here because it is so, so good. Cannot wait to taste the vanilla flavor hint as well. Absolutely beautiful. But let's provide some sounding boards for our beautiful custard, shall we?
So we are doing two different components. I am going to start with a crumble. I'm starting off with some almond flour. Almond. I actually got all the ingredients' name except this, but we are good. We're going to use it.
Oh, and that's gonna crumble up. Oh. That's going to get so crispy. I love it.
You're going to just grill our peaches for us. And this is something you can make in the blender like we are, or you can also use your hands and manually make it. We're going in with our butter. And the secret to this is you don't want to use warm hands. You don't want to overdo it because you also don't want your butter to melt. We're going in with raw almonds. We are going in with some spices. So we're going to go in with cardamom and ginger.
Oh, lovely. I suppose you really want the heady spices for something like this.
They are full-bodied. And we're going in with a bit of cinnamon and a little pinch of salt.
I think, yeah, the part of the food theatre is getting those perfect little griddle marks. So that's my main goal here.
Yes.
Obviously, you don't really need to cook the fruit. We're not stewing it. It's going to have a beautiful flavour profile, regardless of how far you push that kind of caramelisation of the sugars. So you just mainly want the beautiful effect. Are you juggling your fruits about it?
We lost an ingredient, but you will add some zest to.
And we did get some of the zest in, so as long as we get that fresh hit, it's fine. So
that's
fine.
All that matters. So I don't know what it is with graters and this thing. I've warned them I'm not good with it.
Handle with care.
Give it a bit of a blitz.
Oh, wow. It all comes together.
It all comes together, and you want it to be a beautiful texture. In fact, I'll show you. We've got some ready crumble here, and that's what you want.
Oh, the smell of that, the toastiness.
The toastiness.
Is incredible.
And you get that toastiness, but actually, once this is all mixed up, you'll spread it out onto your tray and pop it into the oven, and that's what will give you your beautiful toastiness.
Oh, and you want that. You want the texture of this. It's going to make this meal. You need that crunch.
Ah, now we also need to taste the incredible custard.
Ooh, yum.
Because besides being delicious, Clover's new vanilla-flavoured custard also comes with some major bragging rights. It's made with 75% dairy, and it is 100% real custard. And that's why it is also so smooth and creamy. So let's have a taste.
Cheers to you, sister. Mm.
Oh, it like disappears in your mouth.
Wow, it's gone before it's there.
It's so creamy.
Ooh, that is really good, and you do get that little hint of vanilla. It's not like an overpowering additive. It just sings underneath. Absolute wow, that is good.
It really is good. Oh, amazing. Now it is...
Yummy.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Are you okay there with your peaches?
I think so. I just want that perfect griddle mark underneath.
I think you need to heat up your pan more.
Let's crank it up even more.
Let's crank it up, because I think it's also customary for most people that when you finish your dessert, your seconds is actually just a few extra spoonfuls of custard.
Fair game.
Don't you think?
Fair game.
Most people always go back for seconds.
Here we go. We're getting some beautiful griddles. Look at those.
Oh, that is beautiful.
We are winning at life.
That is what we are looking for. So I'm going to dish up. We've got a beautiful finished one, but we've got an extra one here because we've got all of these beautiful ingredients. We're going to start off with a little bit of our... In fact, I feel like we need to start off with our delicious clover custard vanilla flavour. Yes. And then we'll pop the peaches to the side. So we'll just dish up.
I don't know, it's always a challenge for us when we've got to recreate what our amazing kitchen team have done. So I know we put the kind of the level quite high up there. Don't be too judgmental on yourself, okay?
No, not at all.
With a dessert like this, it all comes together beautifully. The flavour is what we are looking for. But if you can just get these griddle marks right, I think we are winning.
I think you've got it perfectly right.
I think those are great, eh?
We'll put the beautiful sides up and we can place our peaches there. There we go. And then we'll finish off, as Graham puts our peaches down, we're going to finish off with some beautiful crumble.
That looks stunning.
It does look stunning, and I love the sweetness that also comes from the peach flavour.
It's a beautiful fruit to caramelise.
Oh, there we go. If you want to get your hands on this incredible recipe, it is available at expressoshow.com. We've got tasting spoons. We're going to finish off with some fresh whipped cream, little dollops. Look at that. It looks like the...
Oh, exquisite.
Our food stylists. I always love to try and mimic them. It's never a success.
But a little bit of effort goes a long way in the space. Oh, and a sprig of mint. Just the colours that are involved here are beautiful, and they can, I suppose, to an extent, speak to the change in season as well. I don't want this little guy to get left behind.
No, we do not want to miss out on anything. There you go.
And that is exquisite, and it took us all of like 4 minutes to make. I think the real legwork with creating your crumble, definitely worth it to get that textural element, but also the nice heady spices to balance it all out. You get the beautiful sugars coming through in your peaches. Mm-hmm. Perfect combination, and actually quite light because you don't have a massive amount of pastry or sugar involved. It's not over the top. I think it's absolutely perfect.
Absolutely perfect indeed. So to get your hands on this recipe, expressoshow.com.
Oh, that looks great.
Elevate your custard game with the all-new vanilla-flavored clover custard. So creamy and smooth, it makes all the other desserts a little jelly.
Oh, wow, that did look delicious indeed. And we're going to stick to the theme of delicious and oh so scrumptious and get into some entertainment that goes even beyond that. Because why? Nina and Chando are standing by to give us another exceptional performance, and we cannot wait for it. And then we've also got a content creator coming through, Bella Monsoon, in the building. We're going to chat about all things entertainment, all things happening in the world of content, the world of creation, and the world of fun. So, Mzansi, don't go anywhere. We'll see you after this.
It's my feel-good breakfast show. Oh, welcome back, you beauties. You might have picked it up. Yep, we are celebrating young up-and-coming superstars this morning. And we put it to you guys. If your child is going to be that future actor, performer, maybe an Olympian, we wanted you to flex your kids and tell us about their talents. And it looks like we've had a ton of really cool comments come through, as you'd expect, being South Africa.
Definitely. Mm. Let's start off with Megan. She says, we adopted our amazing little boy in 2019. He has always been a warrior in our eyes. Doctors were concerned about his development, and he had many health issues. 5 years later, he is 6 years old, and our son is doing karate. Yay. He is on his yellow level one belt, and after a year and a half, and has 2 silver medals. He is also into engineering and loves coding.
Oh, wow.
He is going to be president one day with his spirit. I love that.
If you do karate and you're coding, you got my vote.
Yeah, man. Plug that into your AI. I love it.
It keeps coming though. We've got Miriam Mguni says, good morning. My firstborn daughter said she wanted to be a fashion designer.
Oh.
Nice.
Don't
and
Angela,
yeah. Angela Dubel also says, good morning, my Espresso morning show. I missed to watch your show. Well, my son is a soccer football player. I mean, I recently found out that while he was telling my mom that he's going to play soccer at his creche, and he's playing for jersey number 2.
Oh.
Right, so he's a defender, right?
All right.
Nice, solid, like a Virgil van Dijk.
You've got
like
to start somewhere, man. You've got to start somewhere. Absolutely brilliant. Keep them coming. We got Caroline saying, good morning, Espresso family. All right, back at you. JD saying, my daughter, Isavile, is in grade R, says that she wants to be a doctor and help us in the future.
I love that.
Doctors as well.
Love it.
Please.
Oh, the future is definitely bright. And then we have a Zelda saying, good morning, all. My son is really amazing at editing videos. He even makes his own little stop motion cartoons.
Whoa. Oh, cool. Please send
that
us one of those. We want to see it.
Oh,
we want to bring him onto the show, man. We love that kind of talent. Please keep him coming. If your child just blows your mind with their passion, with their spirit, with their talent as they emerge, share with us. You can drop us a voice note, 063-408-8863, or any of our social media platforms are a happy playground for you guys today. Go and enjoy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Now it's time to, of course, dive into that beautiful symposium that we promised you. This is Chanda Lupambo as well as Nina Schumann about to perform and for you to enjoy.
Good morning, I'm Nina Schumann and this is Rachmaninoff Opus 11, number 2.
Thank you. It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Now, there is a reason why I get excited about having these kinds of conversations, because they speak to all of us. And whether it's saving for that dream house, maybe our kids' education, or simply to retire comfortably, we all have a financial goal that we are working towards or would desperately like to be pouring energy and time into. And whilst wishing and dreaming for more money to magically appear is one thing and seems to be quite a South African thing, we can all take action today to help ourselves in the most practical way. And it starts with an honest look at our finances, building a budget and then sticking to it. Some consistency, people, are joining us this morning to help us budget our way towards our financial freedom is a very seasoned financial planning consultant from the incredible Alex Forbes, who have been amazing over the last couple of weeks. So please welcome Naomi Chabangu to the couch.
Thank you, Graham. Thank you for having me.
So I'm going to start with the budget itself, because that's at the heart of what we need to achieve here. So in your world, what does a budget look like? What are those key components, and how do we start creating our own budget?
So I always say start simple. You calculate all your income, put it in one bracket, then calculate your expenses, less your expenses from the income, then you'll see what surplus you have. Then when you have that surplus, you can now direct it in other purposes like your emergency income or your savings.
And boy, hasn't the world taught us about emergency income over the last 5 years.
Definitely.
I think everyone in one way or another is still readjusting, maybe not recovering, but readjusting, recalibrating after what we've all been through financially. Everyone's budget is going to look different, and we all have different pressure points and things that motivate us. So in your experience, what should we be considering when looking at our own budget? What do we really need to be aware of?
Just the first thing, be true to your financial situation. You know the needs and the wants that are specific to you and to your life. And then that, after that, you can see, okay, then I can now draft down my budget. Even if it means that, because in the last 5 years it has been tough, even if it means that you have to cut down on certain things, it will come to where you sit down and you do your budget, and then you see that I'm not living the life that is within my budget, then you have to cut down. There's nothing wrong with that.
You can make those choices, but they need to be informed choices.
Exactly.
Expenses are a dirty beast, because often you don't notice the money going out until you do a hard kind of look at what has come in, what has gone out. But with expenses, you might not notice that you're spending 30 bucks a day on a coffee that adds up to a few hundred, that adds up to a few thousand. In your mind, what is the best way to track expenses?
What I would say is, put money aside for unforeseen stuff, or put money for extras. There'll be a column for extras where you say, okay, if I am craving this, because you would, there's times where you'd be craving
something. And sometimes
something.
It's important. Yeah, it means something
exactly.
to you in that moment.
Yeah. In that moment, or
exactly.
you're feeling down and you really want to have that little chocolate. So actually, if you have that extra, that column for extra, you can take money from that, so that you know that you are not juggling out of your budget as well.
What are some of the big pitfalls or the dangers that we need to be aware of when we are laying out our budget?
The first pitfall is not having a budget at all.
For sure.
And thinking, because what I realize when I talk to a lot of people, they think, oh, budgeting brings me a lot of anxiety, because obviously we just want to, everybody wants to spend money however they want to, but at the end of the day, you have to sit down, talk to yourself, and tell yourself that, you know, I want to live this way, and I don't want to be stuck in a cycle where now, half monthly, I don't have money, you know. So you just sit down with yourself and say, you know, I'm going to do this, and I'm going to stick to it, and I'm going to be consistent with it. And if you need help, call a financial advisor. We at Alex Forbes pride ourselves with that. We help clients with every single thing concerning finances, and budgeting is one of them.
I'm so glad you've said that, because I think very often when we want to go to a financial advisor, we think that we've got to have it all worked out or we're going to be judged. What kind of experience will we get working with a financial advisor from Alex Forbes? How does that process work, and will you help us with those, even the most rudimentary steps of just setting up that budget?
We as financial advisors are like, when you are sick, we become your doctor. You understand? We sit down with you, we break it down with you. You don't have to come with us with a plan. We give you that plan. We listen to your personal circumstances and say, you know what, according to what you have given me, I think this is the plan, or I recommend this plan. So you have to come the way you are. Whether you think you are the baddest or you think you have not budgeted for years, we can solve that. There's always a solution. That's why I'm saying, as Alex Forbes, we pride ourselves in giving solutions to people. It starts with a budget.
And I can guarantee, and I've never worked in your space, but I can see just from your face that you have seen things that most of us can't even dream of. So don't think you're going to get judged on your lack of financial acumen. You're going to find, like you've quite rightly put, that GP, that financial GP that is there at your bedside when you need them most, maybe when you need to counterbalance what you're missing out. Mm-hmm. And I think the most important investment we can make in this space is the investment in ourselves by investing in the time spent with an Alex Forbes financial advisor. If I can glean this much just from a few moments, imagine where you could be. And the consultations are free.
Definitely.
You can sign up today at alexforbes.com. Do something today that your future self, maybe your kids, will thank you for. But it all starts with that first step. And in my case, a new budget for next month.
Thanks, G-Man. Well, it is top of the hour. Let's take a final look at your headlines, starting with national news. President Cyril Ramaphosa has reappointed Lesetša Ganyago as governor of the South African Reserve Bank for a further 5 years, with effect from the 9th of November 2024. The presidency said the decision would ensure continuity and institutional stability at the SARB. Nomfundo Chasibana and Rashad Ismail Kassim have also been reappointed as deputy governors of the SARB for 5 years, with effect from the 1st of August 2024. And Dr. Mampo Modise replaces former deputy governor Cuban Naidu, who retired last year, with effect from the 1st of April. And the National Sea Rescue Institute said yesterday afternoon that the charter ski boat Magnum 2 belonged to missing skipper John Matambu had been found wrecked and presumably gutted by fire. NSRI spokesperson Craig Labanon said that during the extensive search involving multiple agencies and a fixed-wing aircraft, the Magnum 2 was found near Dubela on the Mozambique coastline yesterday. Labanon said there were no signs of skipper John Matambu or an as yet unidentified man who reportedly chartered the fishing vessel. A missing persons report has been opened by the police. Moving to news abroad, it took firefighters several hours to contain a blaze in Egypt's famous Al Aram film studio yesterday, and several buildings near the studio in Cairo's Giza district had to be evacuated. Emergency services treated people at the scene for smoke inhalation. The cause of the fire is not yet known. The studio was established in 1944. Several films and TV series were produced there and broadcast across the world. It's reported that the fire broke out 24 hours after the production company had finished filming its Ramadan TV series. And German Chancellor Olaf Scholz has criticized Israel's plans for a full-scale offensive in the southern city of Rafah. But Israel previously defended its plans, saying that they were necessary to bring an end to Hamas in the Strip. Israel's Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu said, and I quote, "No international pressure will stop Israel from achieving all of its war aims." Meanwhile, the first aid shipment to Gaza contained 200 tons of food, including rice, oil and dates. The mission was carried out by US charity World Central Kitchen in cooperation with the United Arab Emirates. And amidst the enchanting setting of Kirstenbosch Botanical Gardens, the adorned Good Luck Band last night captivated thousands of concertgoers with exhilarating news. Ben Peters and Jules Harding delightedly unveiled the gender of their soon-to-arrive baby live on stage, igniting exuberant cheers. "It's a girl," the crowd joyfully counted down to the reveal, enhanced by Jules, Ben and fellow bandmate Tim Walsh, popping bottles to release pink-hued smoke, adding a charming touch to the moment. Ben and Jules, who've kept their relationship private for 15 years, are now eagerly anticipating the arrival of their little bundle of joy, who will soon join them on their life's journey. Jules earlier said they were, and I quote, "giddy with excitement to be bringing a new soul into this wild, wonderful world." Well, we are so excited for them, and that's where I leave those morning headlines.
Thank you so much, so Ben and Jules. We love you. I think another summer anthem is loading. But before we get there, let's delve into this weekend's incredible sporting action. And in a pulsating FA Cup quarterfinal, Man United, they dashed Liverpool's hopes of a quadruple with Amad Diallo's decisive goal in a thrilling 4-3 victory after extra time. So Erik ten Hag's side, they mounted two late comebacks, overcoming Liverpool's lead twice in the match. Scott McTominay, he opened the scoring before goals from Alex McAllister and Mohamed Salah put Liverpool ahead. Then Antony's equaliser forced the extra time, where Harvey Elliott restored Liverpool's lead. However, Marcus Rashford levelled the score once again before Diallo sealed United's win in added time of extra time. Fergie time, baby. United now face Coventry City in their semi-final at Wembley, and that's on the weekend of the 20th and the 21st of April. Well, they didn't get the clean sweep, but they got the title. Ireland clinched their Six Nations title with a hard-fought 17-13 victory against Scotland at Lansdowne Road on Saturday. Tries from Dan Sheehan and Andrew Porter proved decisive as the hosts encountered some stiff resistance from Scotland's formidable defence throughout the match. In fact, it's been strong throughout the tournament. And although denied the chance for a historic Grand Slam following last weekend's defeat to England, Ireland's consecutive title triumphs echoing the incredible achievements of Joe Schmidt's side in that 2014-2015 season. Then we turn to the Africa Games currently unfolding in Accra. And Team South Africa kicked off their African Games campaign in style as we turn to cricket now. And they dominated the hosts Ghana with a commanding 134-run victory at the Achimota Cricket Oval on Sunday. So Captain George Van Heeren, he led the charge with a magnificent maiden T20 century, scoring an unbeaten 107 runs of just 57 deliveries. And that featured 8 fours and 7 sixes along the way. South Africa posting an imposing total of 237 for just 2 after opting to bat first. And Ghana struggled to get going in their chase, managing only 103 for 7. So Team South Africa now set to face Kenya later today at that same venue, looking to extend their winning streak. And speaking of which, we turn to golf now, and world number one Scottie Scheffler made history by becoming the first player to secure back-to-back victories at the Players' Championship with a remarkable 8-under par 64 yesterday, clinching a one-stroke triumph at the TPC Sawgrass. So Wyndham Clark, Brian Harman and Xander Schauffele all finishing just one shot behind Scheffler, with Clark narrowly missing a playoff opportunity after his birdie attempt on the 18th hole, narrowly, agonizingly close, but ultimately did not drop for him. And that's where we leave our sport for this Monday morning. Let's take one last look at the roads.
Thank you so much, Jim. And yes, let's see how we can assist you when it comes to being on the roads this morning. And we move to Boksburg in Johannesburg. Now, there's a stationary vehicle on the N12 westbound, and this after the ramp from Atlas Road interchange. Now, as you can see from the visuals, the right lane is affected, so you can expect delays when passing through this area. But sticking to Johannesburg and in Germiston now, there is mainline congestion on the N3 northbound. Now, this is at Linksfield Road with the back of the queue at Ilans Interchange. So again, as you can clearly see, you need to allow for more travel time when passing through this area, as it is bumper to bumper at the moment. We now move from Johannesburg to Cape Town, and in Bellville, there is congestion on the N1 inbound at the Durban Road ramp. And again, as you can see from the visuals, you can expect delays, so please do maintain a safe following distance. For anybody heading out on the roads this morning, stay safe and buckle up. We now move to the world of weather and find out what's happening one last time. Now for our final report on weather news this morning, the SA Weather Service has warned that extreme high fire danger conditions are expected over the Northern Cape, the central and western parts of the Free State, as well as the southwestern parts of the Northwest. Now, heat wave conditions and persistent high temperatures are also expected over the Northwest, the Free State and the Northern Cape until tomorrow. Now, meanwhile, a fire in the mountains at Harlem, a small town on the eastern outskirts of the George Municipal Precinct, has been contained.
And municipal spokesperson Ntobeko Mangwengwe says light rain contributed to a decrease in temperatures and a reduction in fire intensity. Now, the teams from the Garden Route District Municipality for Fire are working on fire, which has remained on site to conduct mop-up operations and monitor the area through the night. Now, the cause of the fire is unknown, and there's been no damage to the property. Oh, finally, our favorite part of the morning, of course, and that's our sunrise view of the hour. And look at this shot sent by Nzwana, all the way from Durban, KZN. A beautiful shot before the sun even comes through, but you can see that pre-burn just glowing against both the ocean and the clouds, and I absolutely love this picture of the coastline. A beautiful shot. Thank you for sending this through. The number's 063-408-8863, and we'll do it all again tomorrow morning. For now, though, it's one last opportunity for you to see what temperatures you can expect on your side of town.
That seems to have stolen all the sun today. We're going to continue to make it rain lots of cash this March with an estimated 450,000 Rand jackpot today. But that's if you play and play now to stand a chance to make every day Capay Day.
Ah, which definitely. We want. Oh. Definitely. And there are so many ways for you to buy your tickets. You can get it in store. You can get it on the nationallottery.co.za website. You can get your ticket on the mobile app, also through cell phone banking, or simply by dialing *120*7529# for USSD.
And we are trying to make it as easy as possible. We've got all those details on the Expresso social media pages. Go and check them out. And hopefully, as we say, you'll be making it rain the cash this March with an estimated 450,000 Rand daily lotto jackpot today. But you've got to play now to find out if it's going to be coming to you.
Definitely. We are taking a quick break on your Feel Good Breakfast show. Yes, we've had the piano symposium that we're looking forward to, and we've got Reino Boysen ready to bring you a performance.
Mm-hmm. And then as we continue to celebrate incredible young people doing amazing things, Bella Monsoon and Hoheya steps into studio. She is an incredible content creator doing some amazing stuff. We're going to plug you into that in just a moment.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Oh, yes, I'm Zanti. Welcome back to your feel-good breakfast show. What an incredible morning it's been. And I think this conversation is definitely going to spark your interest because joining us right now is Bella Monsoon. Now, she is a multimedia digital content creator and the plug for all things South African true crime, current affairs, and, of course, colourful air. So let's give her a big feel-good welcome.
Aww.
Yes.
Hi, guys.
How are you doing?
I'm good. How are you guys?
Oh, good. Good.
Today's been a bit of a music Monday. It's been a motivational Monday. We've had so many incredible young individuals come and share their craft and talent. And you are one of those young individuals that's super ambitious, but I also love the direction you're taking your social media. And I almost feel like we don't do it justice by saying you're a content creator because you're a distributor of factual information accurate news.
I love that.
Talk to us a little bit more why you've decided to use your social media platforms to highlight everything that's happening in South Africa.
So it's actually really ironic because as a teenager, I used to completely chastise my parents for watching the news. I thought it was so boring and I was like, oh no, you're watching the news again. I can't deal with this. And then we fast forward to a few years later where I have subscriptions to all the major news publications and I create the content that I do. I think it's really just because technology has changed the way that we consume information, consume news, consume media, and it's really amazing for me to be able to reach a different demographic, a different audience that wouldn't necessarily be picking up a newspaper or seeking out the news. Mm. So through my content, I make sure I spread accurate information, not sensationalized, not incorrect, and I keep people up to date with actually what's going on in the world around them.
Yeah, I think it's like a more digestible way of consuming the news from the traditional ways in which we were doing it. But on top of that, you're not just a content creator or a distributor of these incredible facts, but you're also a qualified professional when it comes to just being in the health space, right? Now, does this passion sort of align with what you're currently doing? Have you been able to put the puzzle pieces together?
So I initially kept my life very different. So I had my mental health aspect, my professional career, and then I had my content creation. And about 2 years ago, I started to actually incorporate it because I found people were very interested in understanding a little bit more about how the mind works. And I think with the state of mental health in the country and the world in general, there's a very big emphasis to actually destigmatize mental illness and also normalize seeking help when we need it. Yes. So I think it's really important to align those interests and those passions of mine with my content.
Definitely. I love that you are doing that. But of course, we have to address the colourfulness in the room.
Of course, of course.
I am loving the two tones at the moment.
Thank you.
Your blue and green hair. What is there a reason for it? Is it just is it the flavor or the color of the moment? Is there a specific significance for you?
So I would say it is the color of the moment. I started dyeing my hair, I think it was about 2 years ago. It was very spur of the moment. It was a two-day decision, and I decided, okay, I went from my natural, like, brown hair, and I decided to bleach my hair and dye it purple. And since then, I have cycled through all the different colors. I've done pink, I've done orange, I've done all the different shades. So this is the current summer shade. It's kind of going into winter now, so maybe I'll change it up again. But yeah, I love the colorful hair. It makes me happy. I think seeing color every single morning, it's like color theory, and just the psychology of it just makes me super happy.
You're adding pops of color to what's normally a dreary topic for some, like you mentioned, but I think you're bringing more life to it than ever, and I'm really grateful for that. Beyond the life that you're putting into these stories, into the news that's captivating South Africa, what else would you like to see yourself doing in the future? Because I feel like you're just getting started. The one or two puzzle pieces, look how you've put them together, and I think there's so much more to still come. What do you have planned?
So I would love to obviously grow my community, grow the awareness that I'm spreading. I do a lot of victim stories and narratives of individuals who send me their narratives. So I'd love to be able to grow that platform to be able to share more of those stories. I'd be able to spread more awareness also on safety. I do a lot of that too. I have a safety range, so I make sure that I'm also helping to prevent further crimes from occurring and keep people safe. So that's kind of where I'd like to see the future going. Basically increasing that awareness.
I love that. And you know what? For me, something that's a big thing is so often fake news and inaccurate information gets spread through social media. What is your advice to people that read something to kind of be like, hang on, how can you encourage them to actually check the facts or make sure multiple sources say the same thing?
So that's my number one pet peeve, fake news, especially with recent cases that have been occurring. There's been so much of fake news, and it really affects in a larger scale as well. So my number one piece of advice would be to please Google and check reputable sources. So that means reputable news publications, reputable journalists, before you just share. I know it's easy to just want to share something you got on WhatsApp. I know that that's what happens. Like, someone gets a message and they're like, okay, click share. And it ends up forwarded to so many people.
So
many times. So I would say, please just check it according to a reputable site, because they actually, the journalists from reputable news forums, they do the research to ensure that they spread the correct message, and so therefore you can know that you're spreading the correct information as well.
Well, this is great advice, and again, I can't be even more grateful to have you on the couch right now and to still stick around in the studio, because Mzansi, we are doing all things entertainment with Bella in just a bit. We're going to dive into entertainment news, but before we dive into entertainment news, let's dive into straight up old school entertainment right now.
Yes, and we get the ultimate plug-in this morning, of course, ahead of the incredible Piano Symposium happening from the 3rd to the 7th of April at Stellenbosch University. And part of that, the coveted Henny Joubert Piano Competition, where we test the best in the land against the best. And we've seen performances from Chanda Lupambo, a brilliant young pianist already, and that provides the perfect prelude to this next young gent to step in. He is another student, Reino Boyson, who is about to blow your mind with something truly romantic and beautiful. Take a listen.
Hi, my name is Reino Boyson, and I'll be performing Hymn to Freedom by Oscar Peterson. Enjoy. Thank you.
done.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Oh, welcome back as we dive into the world of entertainment news and catch up with some of our favorite celebrities and find out what they've been getting up to. And of course, it does land pretty heavy sometimes when some of our favorite stars get caught up in the craziness of life.
Okay, well, let's start off with our first story. We still have Bella Monsoon with us, and we would love to hear her take on this. Now, I know you are all about the facts, all about doing your research, so we're just doing this a little bit more on the light-hearted side, although some of the content is on the serious side. So first up, last year, comedian Tall As Mo made some shocking claims after a court ruling vindicated him from the alleged rape of model and actress Lerato Molloy. Now, he went on major podcasts and took to social media to tell those who stood with the actress that the court had proved his innocence. During his sit-down with DJ Fresh on his YouTube podcast show several months ago, he dropped a bombshell that he was traumatized by black women and revealed that he was getting a divorce from his wife. Sure. Now, recently, Tall As Mo has publicly announced his desire for redemption and admitted to experiencing a mental health crisis in recent months.
Look, he has been through a lot. And Bella, I'm gonna throw this to you because these are the kind of stories that you know are going to get sensationalized because they plug into so many trigger points, so many threads that we have to be so careful around. But nonetheless, we will be taken through this very publicly, what should be a very private situation. In a situation like this, calling the mental card saying it's too much, does that land for you in the space? Or is this a case of the media and the public really jumping onto this one and trying to make more out of it than is actually there? When you pick up news stories like this, how does your kind of editorial mind approach it?
Well, I think it's actually a combination of the two. I think the public can also drive a story and make it a lot more than what it is and take a private event or a public event. But at the same time, I think it's too easy to throw the mental health card because there is such a public drive now for mental health awareness. I think it can sometimes become a little bit of a crutch to just go, oh, well, it was mental health. I was having a mental health break. And so I think that's something that has to obviously be looked a lot deeper into before we can just accept that at face value.
Yeah.
Because there are a lot more aspects to the narrative.
Yeah, it's a very complex space.
I feel like I need to pick your brain.
Yeah.
How do you remain neutral? How do you allow not to, your own personal prejudices to be unbiased? How do you
keep
can
it
Can you?
Straight
is that possible?
It is incredibly difficult. You can to an extent. There'll always be your own ideas. There is this concept of a yellow handbag. So it's all your own prejudices, your own beliefs. You put it in a yellow handbag when you are in counselling sessions and you keep it away. And you don't ever take anything out of your yellow handbag and put it onto the table because it disrupts you from understanding the person in a correct manner. And so I think you have to kind of act in that way. You might have your own belief system, but you have to see the situation for what it is. And it's a constant reminder and it's a constant work in progress.
It's a practical element.
It is,
yeah,
completely. You have to be cognizant of the fact that you must take away your own prejudices from situations.
I love that, and that's a massive lesson that I think we often forget about on our side of the lens sometimes. Well, you don't have to put anything away in a little yellow or any other colour handbag when it comes to this particular man. Why? Because we should all be feeling the feels. One of South Africa's greatest ever jazz icons, and now Germany-based musician Abdullah Ibrahim, will be celebrating his big 90th birthday in October. That is incredible. And he is not letting his age get in the way of anything, certainly not doing what he loves the most. Ibrahim is set to evoke some major nostalgia as he'll be touring and is expected to perform in Pretoria and Cape Town this April after a 5-year hiatus at the age of 90. Incredible. Wow. Raul, do you think you'll still be kicking at 90?
Hey? I can only hope so, man. And I think, never mind just making it to 90, but being able to get to that point in time while still chasing your passion, I think that's the reason why he got to that age. And it's so incredible to see that. So I think all South Africans should jump on this opportunity to see a magician at work. What an honour.
Yes, you took a break at 85 and then played.
And then I'm making my comeback at 90. Wow, that's gold.
That is gold.
Well, we've got more news because Halle Bailey is making some news. So after much anticipation, musician and actress Halle Bailey has released her new single, In Your Hands. Now, on the devotional ballad, led by a warm piano, accentuated by dreamy electric guitar, Halle sings about an enduring love. She also explains that the song is very special to her, and it's basically a message about fighting for a love that you know is an incredibly beautiful, one-of-a-kind love, but also a reminder to the special someone that your love has changed their life and is something they won't experience in this lifetime again. Sure. So it is deep and powerful.
Oh, man, if only we could all just sing our thoughts out like this and send that message to the people we love the most in the world. But we love it, and it is so vital that we do approach these stories with an editorial eye, as much as our heart is very much in it. Sabella Monsoon, thank you for giving us that lesson every day in the way that you disseminate, the way that you approach our hardcore news, the soft news. Everything you represent is just amazing, man.
Always
thank you
pleasure.
So, so much. And the hair. I think that speaks to another passion to create.
Definitely. Now, some have a passion to support our creatives in the mentorship role. Mm. And Jikela Studios is an NGO in Khayelitsha with the aim of helping musicians manifest their dreams and reach for the stars. So let's take a look.
So Jikela Studios is an NPO focused on talent development programs, and our goal or our vision is to build a music school here in Khayelitsha. I started as a DJ myself, and then after being a DJ, I delved into being an artist manager. So I've been an artist manager for almost 15 years, 13 years, and what I see or what I get a lot is a lot of young artists coming to me and asking me to manage them, but then I don't have the resources or the funds to do that. And then I was always thinking, what's the best thing I could do for these kids? And then the idea of the NPO came about, and then that's when I decided, let me open up an NPO with my co-founder, Sipho Fagu, and then I think that's the best way we can assist more artists from the township or underdeveloped communities.
The difference that I believe Jikela Studios has made in Khayelitsha is instill hope that we can indeed all make a small contribution. So our larger aim is to create a creative school, but in the meantime, we've been having boot camps, and what makes it different is that we are showing the success or what we can do in collaboration, the success of that. So it's different in a sense that it's not just an individual school, but a group success. And we are hoping that if we can expand these small efforts, we can make a larger impact than what we already have.
The role we've been playing is really just repurposing our skills and, you know, sharing it and in hopes of the mentees that they are. They have these blind spots of not being able to see their own potential, and it's not enough to see it, but, you know, taking the next step, you know, toward propelling your career. It's not that easy to, you know, to just up and manifest your concept. So I think the part of mentorship, I think it bridges the gap, because then, you know, they get to see how someone else has been able to do it, and it makes it much easier for them to execute with that protection and that nurturing, and to just protect their concepts and affirm in the process and help them to cultivate their ideas.
The teaching and the education that mentees and scholars get from Chikela Studios is significant. Here, the difference is that you put in with creatives that already have a skill, and you must make it work with them. So it's more focused on the group effort.
Collaboration is very important, my man, because we can't do things ourselves. You always need people around you to assist you, because you don't know everything yourself, man. Like, I might know this, but then someone else might know something else, and then if we collaborate, the project becomes more, or we reach more a wider audience. So I think teamwork and working with each other goes a long way.
Being a mentee on the Chikela Studios program means that you working on, like, getting as much knowledge as you can, learning your rights as a musician. How is it being on set, making a music video from scratch? It's basically about how to build a whole project. It could be an album, it could be one track, it could be a sequel of tracks, but like it's based on how to build that from scratch, you know, as using the different types of creatives that are involved in a complete project.
I became part of this organization because I saw an opportunity to grow and also to share my skills with others, and to also connect with artists locally, because I feel like with the connections that you make with the people, they can take you very far. You never know who's connected to who. So with me being part of this, I started as a graphic design mentee. This year, I want to work on being a mentor and teach other artists and kids who are going to be part of the program to share my skills with them, and also give them all the insights that I have when it comes to creativity.
There's too much talent in Khayelitsha. We've got DJs, we've got artists, we've got Kriya. There's a whole lot of creatives coming out of Khayelitsha at the moment. And the vision is to build the music school in Khayelitsha. And the reason why we want to start in Khayelitsha is because we feel Khayelitsha is the source right now. It's like the creative hub in the city. And obviously we want to branch out to more townships around Cape Town. And then once we get bigger, maybe go to other provinces like the Eastern Cape and Durban. But now we want to start here.
Just need a chance, just a hand up. I love that mentorship can bridge that vital gap between dreams and make it practical. Yeah. Execution.
That's what it's about, and that's the mission behind the Chikela Studio is NGO. Now, for more on the story, you can visit www.chikelastudios.org, and you can learn so much more about this magic.
Welcome back. Lest we forget, of course, there is so much excitement and opportunity swirling around Tropica Island of Treasure. Why? Because it's heading to Zanzibar and you could too. So we know that our amazing own Zanele is the brand new host for this season. She's going to be amazing. And then, of course, we've got a powerhouse list of celebrity contestants that you could be pairing up with. We're talking about Hongani Ndlovu, Ndavi Nukeri, Nkobile Kwezi, Carl Kugelman, Bobby van Jaarsveld, Chad Jones, and Omihle Gela. Superstars, each in their own right and all very different. Now you've got to join them. You stand the chance to join these stunning celebrities on those gorgeous shores of Zanzibar. How do you get there? Well, you simply upload your audition video to our social media platforms. On your own platform, it's fine, telling the Tropica team why you should be going to the island. And don't forget the all-important handle at MyTropica and hashtag Tropica. And with the process so smooth, you must do everything you can to stand out. We have already had a ton of amazing entries. So you've got to make sure that you show off all your strengths. Find a fun way to do it. Don't be scared of being goofy. That's often when the best content is captured, when you're just being yourself. And we want to see that. And you need to tell this Tropica team with every ounce of energy that you have why you should be heading to Zanzibar for this year's Tropica Island of Treasure. Why? Because you could be winning your share, your half of $1 million if you get this right. So from now up until the 4th of April, you stand a chance of winning your share of 25,000 Rand in cash just by uploading an audition, just by putting yourself out there. 25 grand could be yours. And then the seven contestants actually chosen to head to Tropica Island of Treasure will receive 10,000 Rand courtesy of DPEAT before you even get to Zanzibar. But please mark this down. Auditions closed the 5th of May. Don't have a massive amount of time, so please get on it. And this is your chance to win your share of 1 million rand. It is life-changing, and we know how smooth that is.
Oh, I'm breathing a sigh of relief now because we were just preparing to do something incredible in the kitchen, and Zoe asked, is this a competition?
No, like, I didn't know because it's two stations set up. I'm like, and it's me against Ryle. So I was like, oh, is this a competition?
No, it's too early on a Monday for that. We'll bring the competitions through a little bit later. This can be a competition with yourself, I think, to see if you can make it as good as you think you can. Oh. Right? So it's all about nostalgia for this one, especially seeing that we're diving into the world of Mellows. And I want you and Zanti to obviously get ready for this because this is something that I've brought with me from my childhood.
Okay.
It's something as simple as making s'mores. I don't know if you ever did that by the campfire or
we did.
Anything similar. Yeah.
We did, but I wish I had thought ahead of making it with delicious mellows.
I know, right? So that was the level up, but obviously on Espresso Show, we're going to level up even more and we're going to take this s'more and put it in a wrap and do something absolutely crazy with it. So follow along, Mzansi. Let's have some fun with this one. And as I said, there's something exciting to talk about because we're doing mellow style s'mores. So I know you're going to enjoy this one. Okay. We've got the strawberry flavor too. So
we're going to go for the strawberry. Yeah. So, Raul, talk me through this recipe.
Okay, so normally, obviously, in the campfire, you literally just take your s'more and stuff it between two biscuits, get it all melted and soft, and then chow away. But, of course, with this one, we're stepping it up a bit. So we're going to take three mellows, right?
Okay.
Three mellows and place it in the center. So keep it nice and centered with our wrap right now. So that's your first step.
And
very
easy. And
this is
going to be so nice. Just be careful. You've got some wrapping there.
Thank you so much. And yeah, you can do whatever you want in terms of how you place these together, because at the end of the day, they're probably going to melt and combine with all the other goodness. So don't be too crazy with how you place these together, just as long as they're nice and close, I think. Right. So step number one, pop that in the bin. Step number one is done. Now we're going to take our biscuits. We're going to take two biscuits, right? So normally you take two biscuits and they would be on the outside
yes.
with your sort of mellow on the inside. But this time we're doing it crazily and taking two biscuits and simply plonking it straight on top.
Okay.
Just like that, yeah. Now comes the interesting and unique part where you can either fold, create a rainbow, create some sort of a basket, but we essentially want to cover this all up, right?
Okay.
Does that make sense? So
yes.
you can create a fold like this, a normal fold over, or you can even create like pleats if, you, if you're feeling like you
want to
fancy enough to do that. I don't think I'm at that level yet, though. You might be, but there we go. That's as simple as it is. So I've created my wrap on my side. I see you've got a good swing
a
of
pocket.
Yours there too. Yeah. And now we're literally going to take some of this melted butter and baste that
onto the top of our beautiful rapier. So that's just gonna kind of give it that sort of golden brown texture. Maybe also glue some of the folds together so all that gooey goodness doesn't just ooze out when we're heating this together. But voila, as you can see on my side and Zoe's side, it is done and dusted, and that's ready to go onto the braai griddle. Or the skillet or the griddle, whatever you do have that's nice and hot.
Okay, so I'm gonna go in with it on the griddle.
And I like the side you're using.
Well. Oh,
yeah, have you got space for that? Let me just
I thought I'd seal it first before flipping it, because I know we put the chocolates on this side.
Yes, and I was gonna advise that, because that was the advice I got as well, because I think it would ooze out too much if we didn't seal it at the bottom. So a great tip coming through from Zoe there. Start with the folded side first. First, and then you can seal that together.
So this is obviously hitting a nostalgic element for you. When did this recipe come together for the first time?
I don't think this specific recipe was ever something that I did. Obviously, this is like an elevated version of like the s'mores that I used to use and the mallows that we would get creative with. But I literally think it was my cousin that was one of the biggest contributors to unlocking the nature boy within me. So shout out to Alistair Dream Wilder. That's my cousin. He's a crazy runner and a mountain enthusiast. And I think he was the one that showed me that it's the simple things like this that you can really make memories out of when you're going out on these crazy adventures. It's really simple to incorporate something like a s'more into your recipe or into your moment, and that's what we did. And it's those small moments that provided great conversations, memories, and things that have lasted a lifetime. And look where we are, right here on live TV, sprucing it up and sharing it with Mzansi. And I think anybody that's been on a camp or outdoors can resonate to a meal like this, or
definitely
anything s'more inspired.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Oh, well, listen, when it comes to mellows,
they
are launching a new flavor. Do you have any guesses of what that new flavor could be? Now, you also stand a chance to win one of six Clicks vouchers valued at 1,500 Rand each. Simply reply to the competition post that's on Expresso's Facebook, X, or Instagram pages and submit your guess of what you think the new flavor could be. We have a clue. The baked treat combines the flavors of all spice, nutmeg, and cinnamon.
Ooh.
Don't forget to include that hashtag, let the hunt begin. The competition will close on the 27th of March, and there are T's and C's that can be found on our website, expressoshow.com. I'm gonna give it a bit of a flip because I did turn up the heat.
Oh, it's looking good.
Look at that beautiful little griddle tattoo.
And fast forward into time and you'll get something like this, which you can replicate on expressoshow.com at your service. Nicely done.
Well done. Good recipe. Oh, you can make
my day. We're in Zanzibar for Tropical Island of Treasure. Are you... Did you just swim here from South Africa? There's an easier way to find fame and your share of a smooth million rand fortune. Simply upload your audition to social media, explain why you're a match for our celebs. Add the hashtag Tropica and tag at MyTropica, and we could see you in Zanzibar. Buy a Tropica now and enter to be on the island.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
All right, make it rain. Make it rain. I'm manifesting for you right now. Make it rain cash this March with an estimated 450,000 Rand jackpot. That's just today, baby. Play now and, of course, stand a chance to make, today, payday.
Oh, a beautiful payday it could be. Now, listen, there are many ways to buy your tickets, right? That's including in-store. You've got the nationallottery.co.za website. There's the mobile app, cell phone banking, or you can simply dial *120*7529# and follow the USSDs.
Mm-hmm. And for all of these details, you can head over to the Expresso social media pages. We've got everything there that you need, and hopefully we can manifest at least this for one of you. 450,000 Rand, the daily Lotto jackpot today. If you want to win, you got to play and play now. Good luck.
Yeah, now we've got some stellar musicians standing by to play and do something a little bit different. And I can't wait to do exactly that. So we're talking about Nina Skuman, Chanda Lupambo, as well as Reino Boysen in the building. You've seen what they are capable of. Now let's see what they can do when they combine all these incredible forces.
It's going to get crazy, man. So this is what you get to experience at the Piano Symposium. They're going to be at one point building up to having 20 pianos all playing together off one sheet. It's going to be mind-blowing, but you're going to see the best exponents, some of the best mentors in the business, some of the best up-and-comers all sharing the limelight together. Web tickets is where you find your tickets. And, of course, it's all going to be going down from the 3rd to the 7th of April at Stellenbosch University. But this is one of those ultimates. Whether you're a musician, especially a young up-and-coming musician, or someone who's already established, a teacher, maybe looking for the ultimate in terms of that plug-in and where the art is headed and what you can do to support it, this is where you have to be. But we're going to give you a taste of it just this instance, as we have three incredibly talented pianists standing by to blow us away. Enjoy.
I'm Nina Schumann, and it's a tight squeeze here with Chanda Lupambo and Reino Boysen, and we will do the Libertango from Piazzolla. Thank you.
Get your tickets. Get them now on web tickets. Go and experience that times 110-fold. From the 3rd to the 7th of April, the Piano Symposium happening at the incredible Stellenbosch University. Some of the best musos in the business.
Definitely. Yay. Well, we still have Bella Monsoon with us. And to just end off your feel-good breakfast show, we thought we're going to end off with a feel-good story that's from our entertainment news. Now, TV presenter Michael Strahan, his daughter is battling cancer. And he tapped into his really cool bag of celebrity contacts and got Bryson Tiller, her favorite celebrity, to surprise her while she's getting treatment at home. So let's take a look at this feel-good moment.
The eyes speak a thousand words. Oh, we're going to get that heartfelt one. And I suppose this brings to bear so much of the work that you do, because everything has an emotional trigger point. The joy of being a South African, when you look at the news, it affects you. Yeah. And that should be how it is.
100%.
From that perspective, how do you find being able to, because we battle, I think, being that first plug-in every morning mm-hmm. where we get everybody's load of emotion. I want you to think about that now as we take this on board and share an emotion from someone from the other side of the world right now. But let's hit you in the feels with this one.
It's short and sweet, but absolutely beautiful.
Yeah, you can see how much it means. Yeah. And I love it. Oh, okay, there's more, actually.
Oh,
I suppose if you're going to do it, you've got to do it.
And that makes it official. Once you've done a TikTok with us,
otherwise it doesn't count.
Oh, you're going to open your TikTok account now.
I think after that, I'm going to have to, man. I'm inspired to do it. I think after Bella's come through and taught me all about how much you can do with the platform, I think it's official, guys. You'll find me on TikTok soon.
Yeah, and neither of them will be dancing. Or maybe they will. Or maybe they will. Bella, thank you so much for representing what you do, who you are. You're amazing.
Thank you.
To all the amazing young people who showed up for today, we'll keep showing up for you tomorrow. We'll see you then. Adios.
Love you.
Incredible talent. Thank you.
Elevate your custard game with the all-new vanilla-flavored clover custard. So creamy and smooth, it makes all the other desserts a little jelly.
No.